The following is a special presentation exclusively from Bright House Networks.
Presents the High School Football Game of the Week. Brought to you by the Law Offices of Young Woodridge, Rusty's Pizza, and KERN News Talk 1410.
County Bright House Network subscribers, what a pleasure to have you here. Vance Palm alongside Brian Adams. You can hear the BHS crowd. The Liberty crowd's about to start in. We're literally 3 minutes from kickoff. Brian, first of all, your thoughts on this big, big matchup, the Drillers visiting Liberty.
Plain and simple, Vance. This is going to be whose offense can get off tonight.
First, let's hear from Coach Oliver, the BHS Drillers coach, on what he had to say about tonight's game on both sides of the ball.
All right, the keys for tonight's game, you know, in my mind, are going to be soundness in offense and defense and special teams. A team that doesn't turn the ball over and controls the amount of mistakes they make during the game will have the best opportunity to win.
Well, Brian, we're about ready to kick off here. First of all, let's talk about the Drillers. They're 1-0 in league. They have a tough schedule early on. Are they ready for the Patriots?
Well, they're going to have to be because they're going to need this game so they can try to guarantee themselves a playoff spot because there was a lot of controversy last year when they were 5-5 and got into the playoffs.
What about Liberty? Is there any possible chance with as strong as they are that they would ever overlook the Drillers?
They're not going to overlook the Drillers. Coach Provencal does a good job preparing his kids week in, week out, and they're going to take this game serious tonight.
Let's hear from Coach Provencal on both sides of the ball.
Okay, tonight the key things we have to do is we have to come out and stop the running game led by Matt Mason and Michael Stewart and try to find a way to move the ball offensively. I think if we do those things, we'll have a good chance of winning this football game.
Hey, Brian, that's it. We got to go. We got a buck and a half to get upstairs. Final thoughts on this big game.
Let's just see a good game, a quality game tonight against two good coaches and two good teams.
That's Brian Adams. I'm Vance Palm. Back with a kickoff. Week 7, BHS at Liberty. This ought to be a big one. Back in a moment with the kickoff.
Some things can't be built in a day. Things like honesty, dedication, good hard work, and integrity. Since 1939, the Law Offices of Young Woodridge has had one of the strongest personal injury teams in the entire Central Valley. Today, that team is stronger than ever before. Through the years, our attorneys have won some of the highest dollar personal injury verdicts in Kern County. Put our experience to work for you. The Law Offices of Young Woodridge, integrity you can trust.
That's the end of this quarter. We'll be right back.
You guys hungry?
Rusty!
Oh, he breaks from the pack and heads for the phone.
Give me the phone.
No.
Uh-oh, trouble from the sibling. What's he gonna do?
No.
Oh, look at that. He's doing the frantic finger dash. Let's see that in slow-mo. Nothing can stop him now. Look at that. Rusty's Pizza, on time every time.
Yeah!
101.5 KGFM, your station for continuous soft rock favorites.
You remember me when the west wind.
Listen at work.
I can feel you breathe, washing over me, and suddenly I'm in.
Listen at home.
Something about the way you look tonight.
Listen in the car.
The meaning of being
the artists you know, the songs you love. 101.5 KGFM.
July 14th, 2004, a.k.a. Black Wednesday, a dark day when there are no sports scheduled.
You hanging in there?
I'm managing.
Luckily, Digital Cable brings you in-demand sports packages, so days like these are rare. And you can live sports with access to more of the teams, players, and matchups you can't see anywhere else, plus a unique in-car race experience. Whatever sport you live, add it to your Digital Cable lineup and get access to the teams, players, and matchups you can't see anywhere else.
Kern County, welcome back. Week 7, Game 7, Liberty High School, already a long 35-yard pass from Fontana out there to Scott Wells, and is now first and 10 again on the Bakersfield High School 40-yard line. Ken Berman, about a 9-yard gain. So, Brian, right away, our Kern County audience didn't see it, but it was first and 10 for the Patriots. Fontana dropped back a bullet to Wells. I think that might not be the first time or the last time we'll see that. But here is a shot of Berman trying to get outside, and Liberty definitely on the aggressive offensive side.
Yeah, Berman's going to run through a tackle right there, and here Stewart comes up with a tight angle, and Berman's able to get outside. But you said it, Vance, Liberty's out early striking.
They did get the first down. First and 10 from BHS's 30-yard line. They throw Berman for about a 1-yard loss, and now that we've composed ourselves, got ourselves back up here on time, just barely. We are at the beginning of a very, very big football game in Week 7. Bright House Networks, pleasure to have you with us. Bakersfield High School, 1-0 in league. Always play a tough early preseason schedule. Liberty, one loss on their record, and they're also 1-0 in league. We're just underway, 2nd-and-11 on the first possession of the ball game. Berman out to the right side, wrapped up out there by Jack Ross. So there's a lot to talk about, as always, in Week 7. We'll get to some of our predictions of the other big games going on this evening. And all attention out here on the west side. There's another big game tonight, West High and Stockdale. But personally, maybe that's just because we're covering it, I think this game has incredible significance in the county, Brian.
Well, not only the county, really in the league, because like we said earlier in the pregame, BHS, I think, needs this win because they need to win the league for them to get the automatic bid in the playoffs.
3rd-and-9, BHS defense, early test. The ball is on their 27-yard line. Dominic Fontana, stellar quarterback last year as a junior. This year, he's been even better. He drops back. He's right in the middle of the field. Nothing doing. Great coverage out there by Trenton Francis. We knew his brother last year out here, and Francis basically keeps Fontana from unleashing it, brings up 4th down.
Yeah, that's a good point right there, Vance. The cover was good downfield. You see Dominic drop back. Good recognition. He has nothing already. The pocket's collapsing. Tucks the ball, secures the ball, and doesn't fumble it. Gives his team a chance to kick a field goal.
Number 33, Kevin O'Karski.
Well, this should be a 45-yarder by Kevin O'Karski. Let's see what happens. The snap, a little high, got it down. It's low, it's a bullseye, and it's a low bullseye, doesn't get it. So guess what? Liberty doesn't get in the end zone, and BHS really needed that because we're talking about a first play of the game, a 40-yard strike, and a big run by Berman. So Drillers were on their heels early. They dig in. Now it's 1st-and-10. We're heading south now.
Well, the one thing we know about the Drillers, Vance, is they do have defense. But tonight, they're going to try to put some offense up, and it's going to be behind Jake Scritchfield as he moved up from the junior varsity to varsity to lead this team from the quarterback position, Vance.
1st-and-10. That's a big story, Brian, and we didn't have a chance about it to talk about it early, but we'll sure be talking about that as we go. Just called up for a very big game against,
And already you got two guys moving at the same time in motion, so that's going to be a penalty and moving it back 5 yards. But, you know, this offense cannot afford right now to start off in that kind of hole.
So new quarterback for the Drillers, Jake Scritchfield. His brother Josh, his twin brother, is the outside linebacker and center. They're both juniors, obviously, being twins. 1st-and-15 for this young quarterback called up against quite a team for his first time at the varsity level. Mason on the carry, gets a couple yards. Brian, tell us maybe what your guess is about, well, we have no time. They're in the no-huddle offense. Scritchfield behind center. Quick snap. Oh, Mason slips back there. He did see a big wall of Liberty defenders coming at him, but I believe he lost his footing. Very quickly, let's talk about what you may think the emotions are for this young quarterback right now.
Well, you know, he's probably got to have a little bit of butterflies, you know, a big game against Liberty. This is for first place in the league. You know, but he does have some guys he can rely on that are solid performers in Matt Mason, Stewart, from the running back position, and a line that has to start gelling together there, although they're young.
Big third down early, 8:25 left in the first quarter, third and 16 for the Drillers. Scritchfield's dropped back, first pass this season for the varsity team, and it's a bullet, and it's a first down. Very impressive. Caught out there by number 82, Ian Long, and can't ask for much more than that, can you, for his first pass?
No, you can't, and I was able to get out to practice one time this week and watch the Drillers. And the one thing that they worked on this pass pattern right here, where one guy's streaking, the other guy's running into the corner, and you just he's reading the defense, was giving it to him. And that's just good preparation by the coaches and good execution by the players. And already we're seeing a stronger arm with Scritchfield with more accuracy.
First and 10 Drillers, trap up the middle. Maybe 5, 6, 7 inches. That's about it. That'll bring up second and 10 or second and 9.
You know, advance and running the ball against the Liberty Patriots is tough because they run a 4-4 base defense. So they're going to have 8 guys up there tight. So they're going to have some chances, really, to put some pressure on that running game. I think if they can get Scritchfield going, as we've seen earlier in that pass, and force them to kind of get out that box and get those men out of there.
Matt Mason, Daniel Diaz in the backfield. Ball goes to Mason. Mason loses a yard. That's going to bring it back to 3rd and 10, maybe 3rd and 11. Brian, these Liberty grandstands here are just absolutely packed. Not a seat left. Student stores packed over there. Drillers fans still starting to field in here, so this ought to be a great game. And there's a former Driller right there.
Yeah, that's Coach Provencal, also defensive coordinator. We saw him signaling some plays in. And he's telling them right now, watch the pass. Stay on your man. If he plays that soft zone, they're going to have space to throw the ball.
3rd and 9. Scritchfield drops back, launches it out. It's picked off. Aaron Jost. Well, Kern County Scritchfield was backing up when he threw it. Didn't have a lot of heat on it. And Aaron Jost basically just waiting for it. Took it all the way back.
Yeah, you know, I just said playing the soft defense, the soft three. Coach Provencal that time locks up and goes man-to-man. That was the call. And they do a great job of Jost coming over, picking up the interception, and taking it back to the house for a touchdown, Van.
Extra point attempt from Kevin Okarski. It's up and, wow, no good. So Okarski's had 2 kicks so far. Neither one is good. Both of them are BBs. Here's our Rusty's replay of this interception return for a TD.
You can see right here, Scritchfield is throwing. He has pressure. Ill-advised throw, just trying to get rid of it. He has a big target. But right there, Jost makes a great interception and a great return there for a touchdown.
Well, the Drillers were marching. Right there, they're backpedaling and 6-0, 6:55 left in this first quarter. This is Bright House Network's High School Football Game of the Week. There's a good shot of the Liberty stands. We're talking about pack, not a seat left. And Brian, what a big week for football. We'll get into some of these predictions in a few moments about what's going on. But right now, Drillers are going to get the ball back, but it's because of an interception. It's not because they've caused a safety or something like that, you know?
No, you know, the one thing is they did give up a touchdown, but that extra point could be crucial because the one thing we know is hard to put up a lot of points on the Drillers. Centennial only got 21 and they had 2 a returner in a blown coverage, so, and a fumble and had a short situation where they only had to go 30 yards, so they never drove the ball on the Drillers. So if the defense can settle down, and also Scritchfield just settle down, Coach Oliver talks to him and say, hey, you know, we don't need hero plays out there, we just need you to play solid.
It's a great point. How many times have you seen a missed PAT end up being the deal, you know?
You gotta remember, they went close last year, 16-13, and BHS was driving in and had some penalties at the end that forced them out of the field goal range, but they had a chance.
I was going to talk about that. Last year, big game at BHS. Liberty comes in with a mild controversy. Andrew Horsberger, the running back, ends up being eligible. They had to forfeit some games. Cole Sorrell steps in, has a monster game, what I think was one of the all-time performances for the young Wooldridge athlete of the game. However, BHS could have won it, got down. It was a one-play game. Liberty comes away with a win tonight. We'll see if Drillers can get revenge. Well, there's a nice big boot. It's caught in the end zone, and that'll be it. So Mike Stewart Jr. fields it, but it'll be first and 10 from the 20.
You know,
Brian, you know, the young Woldridge player of the game is becoming a big deal here in Kern County, where I walk around and I'm at the park the other day with my girls and ran into a high school football fan and said, hey, you know what, Eric Alford last week against South, that was a great pick. That was a great pick. They didn't win, but five TDs, and he also ended up being Athlete of the Week in the California, so stay tuned. First and 10, Driller ball. Scritchfield in the backfield. Hands off to Matt Mason. We know Matt Mason has the speed. There's no doubt about that. Just needs to find a hole and get some nice blocking up front.
Well, I like that play right here. This is going to stretch it out and just toss it out to the left and let him go outside and use his speed to pick a hole on the Rusty's instant replay. But again, it stretches that eight-man defense out, so there's holes for Matt to throw it in. But as a penalty, just brings it back, so it was all for nothing.
Flag on the play. Oh, goodness. Brian, what was it called, you know?
They called holding.
It was a holding. Maybe that's why he got that 9-yard gain, because something was happening out there that was not allowed. Brian, I want to ask you a question. You know, this offensive line for the Liberty Patriots, we haven't seen that much of them yet, but when they get out here in the field, obviously it'll be a topic for us. Adam Heron, 6'3", 265 pounds. Steven Alvidris, 6'3", 265. Of course, very much talked about Corey Actis, 6'5", 270. Big, big line. We'll talk about that in a minute. But first, it's the Drillers. First and 15. Mason trying to get outside. Cuts up. Gets maybe 4 yards, 5 yards up to the original line of scrimmage. That'll be a second and 10.
Yeah, you know, and this is where a young line kind of hurts you if you're an offensive team for Coach Oliver. You know, they're going to make some mistakes, and they're having a hard time blocking those front eight of the Liberty Patriots. But I think they had to find a way to spread them out and get the passing game going to pull them out of that defense so they can create some room to run.
You're watching High School Football, the game of the week on Bright House Networks, exclusively for you subscribers. Hello, Kern County. Less than 6 minutes left in this first quarter. It's 6-0. Liberty leads the Drillers. Mason alone back. Mason gets the call. Maybe a yard, I doubt it. So that'll bring up third and long for this Driller team.
And what we're seeing right now, Vance, on the Rusty's replay, we're just seeing the defensive line for Liberty just take it to the BHS offense right now. I mean, they're just dominating them on the running plays, and that's just sucking it up to you off in the lineman and say, hey, I'm not having this anymore.
Third and 16. Scritchfield drops back. The ball is tipped. Caught by, I think, the quarterback himself.
Looks like Titus' pass was tipped. Can't see who came down with it yet.
Well, regardless of who caught it, it's fourth and long. Drillers will punt.
And they were flirting with disaster again, Vance, with this tipped ball right here.
James Stansberry comes up with it to the Drillers.
So couldn't really see who tipped it there.
Fourth down.
But luckily, the Drillers were able to retain possession and force a punt.
Number two, Gordon Cooper.
Fourth and 12, Drillers punt caught on the 30-yard line by dangerous Jay Williams. Jay Williams trying to get out bounds. He cannot. He's wrapped up in there by Jack Ross.
There's a flag down here, too, so this could be on the return team here. There's a flag down, though, Vance.
Let's find out here. It is against the Drillers.
No, the Patriots.
I'm sorry, against the Patriots. 4:26 left in his first quarter. Jay Williams, superstar receiver from last year, that hookup with Fontana. Man, they're having another great year, and we'll get to some stats here in the second quarter. Jay Williams, also a hoop player. So backs the Patriots up to the 27-yard line, first and 10. That big offensive line that Fontana gets to work behind. Haven't seen much of this offense already. Fontana to Berman. Berman gets nothing. Second and 10.
Four,
hey, Brian, now that we've caught our breath, let's talk about your B's three for Liberty.
Okay, fans, when we're talking about the B's three for Liberty, we're going to talk about first, the big three must come to play. That's Cole Sorrell on defense, Jay Williams, and Dominic Fontana. If they have a big, huge game, could be lights out for the Drillers. They have to force BHS in third and long. We've already seen them do that, and they've had success on interception. They got to play with poise. They cannot get the silly 15-yard personal foul penalties, unsportsmanlike conduct.
Thank you, Brian. Fontana, three drop step.
Fontana's pass complete. Officials ruled incomplete.
Almost intercepted simply because of the bounce of the ball. He fired one about 6 yards away from where he was standing. It bounced up, almost picked off. That'll bring up third and 10.
We got to get credit. That was a great hit right there by the defender. He just dislodged the ball.
Third and 10, Patriots.
From the receiver.
3:45 left in the first quarter. This is Vance Palm alongside Brian Adams. What a football game. Fontana. Got the I formation behind him. Drops back. He's got all the time in the world. Looks like it's going to be set up for a screen. Wants to run. Cannot get out of trouble. And look at this. Thrown for a 9-yard loss. And that will bring up fourth and long. The Patriots will punt. So not the most impressive drive.
Well, the one thing, like I said earlier, is whose offense can come alive, because we know these defenses can play. And right here, this is just a coverage sack. When the quarterback has this much time and nobody's open, give the secondary and the linebackers good coverage, and also give the defensive line the effort of not stopping to continue to put pressure and getting a sack.
Deep for the Patriots, Mike Stewart Jr. And there's
penalty on BHS. They weren't ready for special teams. Didn't get them in off in time.
Oh, well, laundry on the field. And as hard as these teams prepare, as much work as they go through during the week, as much emotions as they try to bottle up and get ready for a big night like this, the very last thing the coaches really want to deal with are mistakes like this.
That's unacceptable. At this point in time in the season, those things shouldn't happen. You know what team you're on. You get on, you get off.
Instead of 4th and 17, it's still 4th and 12th, so a tribute to the defensive efforts. Oh, almost blocked. I don't know how it got away. Mike Stewart, fair catches at the 44-yard line. So the Drillers will take over in very good field position near midfield. And, Brian, if there was ever a time for the Drillers to get a spark going right now, this is it.
Yeah, this is it right here. And Vance, you said exactly, they got great field position, and that's one of the things that I was talking about the Drillers when we get up to them. We'll talk about their beast three, but they've got to get some good field position to give this offense a chance.
In a moment, we'll get Beast 3 for Bakersfield High School. And Brian's an alumni of that great, great football program. First and 10, Drillers. Just under 3 minutes left in the first quarter. Scritchfield out to the left. A nice, nice pass. Hey, look at this. Has this got some speed? Gordon Cooper trying to get in the end zone. One man to beat. A head tackle. Gets down to the 5-yard line. A touchdown is saved by Anthony Hainelt. But, Brian, this was one well-designed, well-executed play. Here's our Rusty's replay.
It is. This is a quick throw out to the receiver. You let him go one-on-one, see if he can make a move. Gordon, a good athlete, gets out there, runs by him. And right here on the instant replay, I just thought he started putting the cruise control, thinking he had it. But you got to give credit and hustle from
Anthony Hainelt.
Anthony Hainelt, because he hustled and saved a touchdown, which could be a big play, because one thing they haven't been able to do tonight is the Drillers have not been able to run the ball on this defense.
Jake Scritchfield, junior quarterback, hands the ball to Mason. Mason pounds his way in. Touchdown, Drillers. And look at this BHS crowd. They are fired up. Coaching staff staying calm, cool, and collected, but the BHS crowd loving this right now. 6-6. Brian, give me your thoughts. What are you pointing to, my friend?
Well, we have this year, I think this is our first young lady kicking the ball.
Alyssa White.
Alyssa White.
She's looking to put us up by one. If you're a Driller fan, it's up, and she does it. 7-6.
And I'll tell you, Vance, I was talking to Coach Hinn earlier about her leg. He says she can kick from 40, and I think he might be right. That could be a weapon for him tonight.
Alyssa White, 5'7", 130-pounder. She's a senior. And she's been able to do something so far tonight that hasn't been able to be done by the other kicker, and that's put it through the uprights, Brian.
That's it. And again, if it stays 7-6, could be a crucial play.
Hey, Kern County, if it stays 7-6, guess who our young Wooldridge athlete of the game would be? The kicker that made it. Hey, Brian, Beast 3 for your Drillers.
Establish a running game. They haven't been able to do that yet, but that's what they need to do. They had a good run for that touchdown. Two, the D must give offense good field position. Point from that last play, forced a punt, good field position, two plays, touchdown. And last, I think they need to get a big return for special teams, whether it be a kickoff or a punt. They need something to happen good in special teams.
Number 2, Williams, number 81, Wells.
Brian, here's our TD.
Yeah, and that's just a good blocking scheme right there. You see Big Mason coming through there, running in there. Nice, easy run. Puts the shoulders down, gets north and south. And follows Big Calvin, Daniel Calvin right through the hole.
Well, Liberty's sixth in defense in the county. BHS is seventh in defense. And I'll get to that and why I said it in just a moment.
Williams picks it up.
Kick is fielded by Jay Williams on the 12-yard line. Jay Williams gets up to about the 30-yard line. Pretty nice return up there. So Driller's seventh in the county in defense, and right now they need to prove it.
Well, and you got to remember, when we're talking about these stats from the paper, they can be a little deceiving because certain teams play tougher schedules. Drillers obviously play the toughest schedule, I feel, in the area, probably next to Centennial. They do it every year, both those teams. So when you're talking about their seven.
That's a strong seven.
That's a strong seven. So, you know, I think the defense is legitimate, and we'll see tonight. Now, also, Liberty has a great defense. So you're talking about two of the best defense in the county.
And Liberty has number four offense in Kern County. First and 10, 2.5 left in the first quarter. We got a nice ball game brewing here. Berman battles up to about the 32-yard line, a tough 2 yards. And we've seen Berman on the highlights throughout the last 6 or 7 weeks on our affiliates, and he's done a fine job of running the ball this year.
You know, in Vance, he did a good job of not getting tackled in the backfield. He ran through the play, and he picked up some positive yards. But Vance, right now, the offensive lines on both teams are just getting handed to them by the defensive lines. That's just plain and simple for the first quarter so far.
Goodness. An offensive line like Liberty getting taught a few things. Goodness gracious, intercepted. Look at this, Driller fans. You may be stoked. Hey, that's Mike Stewart Jr., and I don't know if you could design it any better as far as a defensive effort. And Brian, I think we'll just pause for a moment and watch this crowd celebrate.
Well, I'll tell you, Vance, they did the same thing back to the Liberty Patriots. Stewart did a good job of coming out of his break, settled down as soon as he saw Jay stop. He broke, came underneath Jay, and made a big play interception for return. That's a great defensive play. And you got to think that he knows a little bit of something about making those plays from his dad talking to him.
Well, for all of you longtime Kern County football fans, you know the name Mike Stewart. Let's see if Alyssa White.
White out to attempt to punt after.
Can put this through. She does, and it's 14-6. Drillers lead. Mike Stewart with a big, big interception. And his dad's not the only one that's super stoked over there. Here's Fontana.
Right here. He's going to try to throw that little out to Jay, and does a great job of staying with the ball. Good hand-eye coordination, following the ball to his hands. And right here, Jay Williams, if there's one thing they're going to have a knock on Jay, is speed. He didn't have the speed like Michael. So once Mike pips that ball off, there's not going to be any catching him.
Well, Kern County, Liberty, first play of the game, 35, 38-yard strike from Fontana to Ross. Next thing you know, the Drillers hold them. Liberty picks it off. It goes back 6-0, but then it's been Drillers, boom, and now got a pretty interesting ball game getting going here, Brian.
Yeah, it is, and you got to remember, when you talked about the stats earlier, Vance, when we talked about offense, it's a different offense for the Drillers now. They have a different quarterback. They have a quarterback with a little bit lighter arm and a little bit better accuracy. So, therefore, we really don't know what BHS's offense is, and we're going to see tonight what they're all about.
The coaching staff of the Drillers, head coach Jason Oliver, assistants David Hinn, Rasheen Shahi, Sean McCowan, Brian Walker, Don Crow.
And a lot of people will know Rasheen Shahi. Played at Foothills and played with the Chiefs for a few years. And also did a little stint in the XFL. And David Hinn is an alumni of a CF title team, two CF title teams.
Williams has protection. He's got a nice wall up here to run behind. Gets out of the 40-yard line. I wanted to say he had protection. Well, truly he did in one sense of the word, but the vernacular not being a quarterback. But he gets up to the 40-yard line. Hey, here comes Liberty again. Let's see if this offensive line can get going. Let's take one more look at Jay.
And great return right here. They're going to come out with a left return. Good job of guys getting in the lane and picking up white jerseys. You see right there, there's nobody even near him. He's already to almost 35, 40 before he even gets touched. Great setup and special teams play.
First and 10, Liberty on their own 41-yard line. This crowd a bit pensive. I won't say filled with consternation, but certainly thinking about things. Berman tries to get outside, no dice. Wrapped down at the 40. I don't think it's a gain at all. And what I've noticed so far, not just the lines, in the trenches, but those linebackers and DBs from Bakersfield High School really pursuing well.
Yeah, and they're having the opportunity to make those plays because the line is penetrating, slowing up in the backfield. And right there, that's the defensive end right there, Worthy. You see, he's 6'5", 230. That's a lot of young men out there to block on that corner.
Head coach Chad Provencal, Kirk Boyer, offensive coordinator, Dale Tedrow, Paul Rocha, Jeff Larma, and Bill Richardson. We'll talk about those coaches as the evening go along. As the evening goes along. We're just under a minute now in the first quarter. Berman, goodness gracious, he is popped out there by Greg Diaz, and that'll make the news tonight.
Yeah, the one thing we know about the Diaz boys, they play hard and they play physical. And you're going to see right here, Berman's just going to get stopped right in his tracks by Diaz and driven right into the turf. Great play, great form tackle.
Wow.
And Vance, I think that Liberty has to use their height. They have a height advantage over the Driller defensive backs. You have to go downfield like you see with Randy Moss and the tall receivers in the NFL and college. Give them a chance to use their size.
Most likely last play of the first quarter, 20 seconds left. Williams in motion. Fontana takes the snap at 15 seconds, and I thought it might have been a hair too long. Let's see. Clock has stopped.
Flag on the play.
Either that or somebody move. I think you're right on that, though, Vance. Oh, false start there.
False start.
I think it was one of the tight ends on the end.
Well, this will most definitely be the last play of the quarter. Wow, I shouldn't say that. Clock is ticking. They started it up. 9, 8, 7, 6. I doubt he'll get this off, Kern County. Hey, that wraps up the first quarter. You're watching Bright House Network's High School Football Game of the Week. The visiting Drillers, 14. The home squad of Liberty, 6. I'm Vance Palm. I'm alongside Brian Adams. I know you'll be back right after this break.
That's the end of this quarter. We'll be right back.
You guys hungry?
Rusty!
Oh, he breaks from the pack and heads for the phone.
Give me the phone.
No.
Uh-oh, trouble from the sibling. What's he gonna do?
No.
Oh, look at that. He's doing the frantic finger dash. Let's see that in slow-mo. Nothing can stop him now. Look at that. Rusty's Pizza, on time every time.
Yeah!
101.5 KGFM, your station for continuous soft rock favorites. Listen at work.
I can feel you breathe, washing over me, and suddenly I'm there.
Listen at home.
Something about the way you look tonight.
Listen in the car.
Meaning of being.
The artists you know, the songs you love. 101.5 KGFM.
Hey, Kern County, welcome back. Vance Palm alongside Brian Adams. The score is Liberty 6, Bakersfield High School 4. And that's the kind of score so far that if they gave it at halftime at some other high schools around here, you'd hear the collective, ooh. After this play, Brian, I want to hear your thoughts on what we talked about in the break right now. First play of the second quarter. Hey, look out, Fontana in trouble. Hey, Kern County. A nice play out there by Chris Watkins. Watkins on the... The blitz and Brian, the mental preparation and the thought process right now from the Drillers coaching staff is pretty nice.
Yeah, right there, Vance. You got Watkins coming over and making the tackle off that end. And I saw him in practice against the first team offense, Vance, and he was causing problems in the running game with his aggressiveness and his physicality.
Well, that brings up 4th and 30, second play of the second quarter. Deep for the Drillers is Mike Stewart. He's already scored on an interception. Oh, it's a pretty tough punt to stomach, but I'll tell you what, it took about a 30-yard bounce. So it was about a 10-yard punt and a 30-yard bounce, and that brings it up to the Bakersfield High School 47-yard line. Brian, you said something at the break that just resounded through my hollow noggin, and that was, hey, Vance, we've talked about it. If drillers get an offense going, they're tough.
Yeah, they are, because they play. One thing people don't realize in town, they may not or may realize, is they play a lot of defense because the offense so far has not been able to sustain drives or move the ball. So your defense is playing a lot of time on the field. So for them to have those kind of stats, they are a dangerous and a great defense.
Here comes an energized driller offense behind the quarterbacking of a junior quarterback, and look out. Looked like a backward pass to me, and Gordon Cooper, thinking pretty quickly, jumped on that baby.
Yeah, good job right there of getting it just a little low out there. You got to get the ball out there to him so he can stand up. But that's going to be close to whether it was a backwards pass or not. Hard to tell from that angle.
And it didn't look as if Scritchell had a real good grip on that ball from the very beginning of the play.
No, it didn't.
Well, no loss as far as yards, but boy, they had some momentum going. You thought that if they got that first playoff and started charging, anything could happen. Second and 10 for the Drillers. They're up by 8. Jake Scritchfield, first game at varsity level, and what a game he's having so far. Hands the ball at the middle to Mason. Mason, no gain there, and hasn't been a lot at the middle. And we pretty much figured that with this line.
Yeah, and it may not be, but the one thing that I like what Coach Oliver did that time is he brought in extra receivers. He spread out the defense, and what that does is it takes you out of that 44 defense, 8-man front. You have to walk out on those receivers, so there's going to be room to run if they can just figure out where to go.
That's the voice of Brian Adams, high school class of 1990 at BHS. We'll talk about some things that happened today between one of my mentors discussing Brian Adams. Here's Jace Crisfield, drops back, launches it up. Pretty good route, and he had some real estate out there, overthrew it, probably wisely, averted any kind of disaster. That brings up 4th and 9, Drillers will punt.
Yeah, and that's a good shot, you know, and that's something you can put that Coach Oliver's calling his off play. He's gonna put that back in his little notes and say, hey, we can come back to that play.
Yep. Drillers will punt. They're already lined up, ready to go. Not messing around whatsoever. Jay Williams back on his own 12-yard line. The punt is up, and it's a beauty. It is big and a high, high spiral. Williams catches it on his 2-yard line. He is quick. Makes the tackle. Looked like it should have been a clip. Not called, so that'll be 1st and 10 Liberty ball. You know, this Liberty team is so talented, so powerful, so potent that you know they're always in the ball game, you know?
Yeah, they are. You know, and right here we're going to see the return by Jay right here. A good job, one, filling the ball. He doesn't panic. Makes a nice little move to get outside. And I think you're right, Vance. I think we're going to see a little bit in the back there. It's just a snap, but by rules, that's a block in the back.
Listen to me, the basketball player.
Kind of looked like Dante Hall's little play. Once
First and 10, Patriots. Dominic Fontana. Looking, fires one out. He makes the really nice pass out there to Chad Sorrell. Chad, younger brother of Cole Sorrell. He's a junior this year, and he's having a decent season as well. And here's our Rusty's replay. Fontana's got a nice arm.
Yeah, and you see right there, good catch by Sorrell out there. Does a good job also going upfield and delivering the hit there on Stewart.
9:44 left in the second quarter. This game has been flying by. Some big plays, some good plays, some hard hitting, and the score is 14-6. BHS up on Liberty. 2nd and 4 for the Patriots. Fontana off to Berman. Berman tripped up early, really can't get going, and it's going to be 3rd and 4 if they gained anything.
I tell you, fans, these O-lines so far on these running plays, they have not been able to block the other defensive line across the line, the men across the line from them. And whoever's team can end up doing that, I think, is going to have the advantage in the rest of this quarter, the second half.
You know, and that was one of the big stories we were going to try to, you know, filter in throughout the evening, the offensive line for Liberty. And, you know, how can you not talk about this line with Big Actis and, you know, Adam Heron, and you got Alvidrez. These are big guys up there. But right now, it's 3rd and 3, and it's a big third down for Liberty. This crowd is a little bit quiet, a little bit nervous. Fontana rolls right, looks across the middle. A beautiful strike, and this might be a fumble. It is. Mike Stewart has his second pick of the evening. Well, that's basically a fumble pickup, but it's all about drillers being first down and 10 right now on the Liberty 26-yard line. And, Brian, as we see a picture of this VHS crowd, it's probably impossible not to be pumped up.
Well, I think they have some things to be excited of. One, the defense is getting turnover, but two, they know they have something in their offense that is gonna that might work for them. And right there, just a great play there. Looked like Diaz made the play there.
Sure did, Daniel Diaz.
Daniel, and then Stewart did a good job of staying with the ball, picking it up, and turning into an offensive player. You know, he's a running back, and here he is, picking up some positive yardage, and once again,
wow,
great field position for that offense.
First and 10, drillers on the Patriots' 27-yard line. Diaz. Up the middle. You bring up an interesting point. Jake Scritchfield, junior quarterback, comes up. Not taking anything away from who had been playing quarterback, but sometimes a position change, somebody comes in. It's just it's one of those natural human nature things. You get pumped up, you get a little excited, you think maybe this is the key. You never know. Second and 8. Your thoughts on that, Brian, after this play? Scritchfield. Pitches out to Mason. Can Mason get outside? He makes one good cut, but not going to get it done against this Liberty defense. Brought down out there by number 31, Keith Legro. Let's talk about that. Quarterback moves up, although he's a junior. He's been playing GV. Your thoughts?
I'm going to tell you an example like that we experienced when I was at UCLA. My sophomore year there, we see this replay right here. Matt Mason just picking up some yards, does a good job cutting inside, then getting back out, but defense closes.
Continue.
But the one thing I was talking about is Tommy Maddox is our leader. That year, we had got to, I think, number 5 in the country.
Tommy Maddox playing for the Steelers.
And we thought we had a chance next year to make a run for the title. Tommy goes to the pros. We get a different quarterback, and we didn't have the same belief in him.
Oh, goodness. Scritchfield had a man wide open, and that was Darnell Worthy right across the middle. Would have been a nice pickup, but instead brings up 4th and 8, and we'll see. We'll get to see Alyssa White's leg strength, or will the drillers go for it here on 4th and 8 at the Patriots' 26-yard line? It would be about a... after the place and the hold, it would be about a 40-yarder.
And they're calling timeout.
Okay.
And the thing about it, Vance, and you talked about it, I keep going on it, is it's not that one quarterback is much better than the other quarterback. It's how the team feels. And I could just tell when they came out today, you could just see the offense. They came out with a little pop, bouncing a step. So they believe some things can happen with Scritchfield at quarterback. He's made a couple nice throws and had a couple missed. But I think as he settles down and gets comfortable with the varsity-level quarterback, Vance, we're going to see him make some really good plays from that quarterback position for the drillers.
Well, Brian, Bright House Networks, the digital video recorder, the pause and rewind and live TV. I mean, hey, we're talking about what makes Bright House Networks so great. Order digital cable from Bright House Networks before October 31st and automatically be entered to win a new Suzuki XL7 SUV from Golden State Motors. Call 323-4892, the digital video recorder. You can rewind and pause live TV right from your remote control. And on a game like this, I can see where that come into play immediately if I was sitting on my couch. Hey, look at this, Kern County. You got to love it. 4th and 8. The drillers and a big play here in the first half. Scritchfield pumps downfield, fakes, lobs one up. I don't know if it's anybody, and no flags, and that'll be first down for Liberty. A hard pump down the left side, and then he looked up, and I just don't know if those receivers could break away from those DBs.
Yeah, Martin just couldn't quite get to where the ball's going, but I tell you, I like the way they're attacking. You know, and also, I've been telling the line not having problems early. They're giving them time in the passing play. There were only 6 guys that time in the box, and they were able to block them and give Scritchfield a chance. And Martin was just a little bit short of getting to the point where that ball needed to be, but it was also a throw where it was placed in the right spot.
Kirk Boyer, working with the offensive line in pregame, said, fellas, this game will be won in the trenches with you. Let's see. 1st and 10, Liberty. Ball goes up the middle.
Number 43, Chad Sorrell, your ball carrier.
Chad Sorrell gets 1 or 2 or 3 maybe tough yards in this Liberty crowd. And, you know, they're just kind of hoping and hoping and hoping something happens.
And that's just a dive play here on the Rutgers replay. And Sorrell does a good job of holding to the ball. He's able to pick up 5 yards, so it looked like it was a little bit of nothing, but it comes out to be a big 5.
Man, He got five out of that, and I thought it was maybe two, so the strength. That Sorrell family, goodness. Second and five, Patriots, just under 7 minutes left in the first half. They trail by eight. The ball. Handed off to number nine, Nicholas Weaver. He's a 5'9", 175-pound junior, and I don't know if he got anything. Maybe a couple inches, but okay, they give him a yard, third and four.
And they were a little generous on that one.
And, you know, Brian, the last big third down for Liberty was last series, and it was a fumble. Here's another big third down. 6:20 left in the first half. Bright House Network's high school football game of the week, and we've got a doozy. BHS at Liberty. Fontana is going to pass. Drops back. He rifles one over the hand on the head of Chad Sorrell. And,
there's a flag down there by the quarterback, too.
We've got laundry. We see a driller clapping. I see
holding. That's
Jonathan
why he's
Heed.
That's why he's clapping. He might have been the one to get held right there, huh?
Well, Brian, it's third and four now with the penalty. Obviously, you don't want to decline, make it fourth and four, or do you? Fourth and four?
I think you let him go out there and punt. Because you got to remember, Vance, Jay Williams is very dangerous. And you don't want to give him another chance because you're talking about being third and 14. He can make that and turn that into a touchdown if he gets a good play one-on-one.
You mentioned Jay Williams. Haven't seen a ton of him yet from the line of scrimmage, but we have seen him on returns. Mike Stewart at the 35-yard line. It's another high punt and not a long punt. Not the best punting night so far for Liberty. This one bounces back up to about the 48-yard line. So the drillers are not lacking for good field position this game, are they, Bri?
No, it's not. And I'm going to tell you, Vance, where it wears out on you. If this continues quarter after quarter, you get to the fourth quarter, that defense gets tired. And all of a sudden, those runs, who are getting stopped for 2 yards, they start going for 6-7 yards.
Well, the punter for Liberty, Andrew McAtee, I'm sure he's a fine, fine punter. He has had two in a row here that really haven't helped out his squad much. Just under 6 minutes left in this first half. Here come the drillers again. Jake Scritchfield behind center. Scritchfield hands it to Mason. Mason now starting to feel his way around here. That's a fine piece of running. And we've got laundry on the field. I hope they don't have to pull that one back. Simply from the standpoint that was a pretty good run. And he was patient and he waited. But let's see what the laundry is.
If they pull that back, that'll be the second one time that he's busted about a 9-10 yarder. And they called it back because of holding.
Yep. Pretty quick discussion. Not even a discussion between the referees. Maybe just a one-word deal, and that was it. So a really nice run by Matt Mason, but you can't break the rules, can you, Brian?
No, and it had to be a receiver out there because that's where the flag was thrown. And you got to remember, from a receiver standpoint, that's the easiest place to get called for holding because you're out there on the island, everybody can see it. And this was right there. Yeah, it's not even close to a call. And the sad part is when you're a receiver and you get done called for holding, and that's happened to me and anybody who's played receiver, is you know if you're getting called out there, it's already an 8-9-10 yard run.
Great point. 5.5 minutes left. Here's a pitch to Mason, and Mason makes another cut up, and now he gets about 5 yards back. So that's a great point. And it just hit dawn on me now. If you're a receiver out there, young guys, young gals, if you're playing football, and if the hold is on you, that means a nice play is already developed, and they're coming right up you.
Yeah. So you can imagine you kind of sit slumped down in your seat during film. But here it is right here, just a pitch out. And right now, you're starting to see that defense get worn down a little bit, I think. And here's on the Rusty's replay, and Mason's able to pick up 5 yards.
Second and five, drillers. Hard count. Didn't get them, or did they? Mason cuts up field. Mason, nice job of running there and gets the first down. Hey, first and 10, drillers. Liberty. Start digging in now, Brian.
And that's why offensive coordinators, Vance, hate to go three and out. Not so much because the offense is stalling, because they know that they're putting too much pressure on the defense. See, right here, it's just a play back to the same play to the right, ran to the left, and Mason does a good job of taking it upfield and running strong with the ball.
Matt Mason, 5'11", 170-pound senior. He's a running back, he's a DB. We had him last year.
First down, Driller.
On our Bright House Networks telecasts, and he's certainly made a name for himself the last couple years here in Kern County. Up the middle, Mike Stewart.
On the five, Stewart, your ball carrier.
6 yards, 7 yards. That'll bring up second and four.
You know,
advance, I mean, beginning of this game, that defensive line, they were making tackles in the backfield. Now we're starting to see, they got their hands on their hips. Look at them, they're sucking up for that air. So playing a lot of defense is starting to wear on them.
The score is 14-6. BHS leading Liberty. It looks like we've got a timeout, or it's just an equipment timeout. The head official is fixing the helmet himself, kind of a handyman ref out there, and he's saying, hey, Daniel, that's Daniel Diaz. You hit pretty hard, my man, so let me make sure that's all geared up. Hey, Brian, today I'm up at Green Frog Market working the produce, flinging lettuce, pears, apples, celery, and who walks in but one of my mentors and one of your favorite guys, Chuck Chamberlain. Right after this play, we'll talk about the legendary Arvin High coach and what he had to say about you, my friend. Just under 4 minutes. Drillers up the middle. Mike Stewart almost broke it, but he gets up to about the 29-yard line, and that'll bring up third and two, third and three. You know, Brian, Coach Chamberlain, we were running through the annals of high school football and the teams and the leagues and things that are going on this year, and he said, boy, I'll tell you what, your partner is probably one of the most impressive players I ever watched come out of Bakersfield, and he went on to play at UCLA. That guy right there was great, and we'll talk about that game in high school football 1990 when you play the Bears. 3:20. Daniel Diaz with the carry. This will be awfully close, and while we're waiting, that'll give me a chance to ask you about your senior year in 1990, and that lady might have been there saying, go, Brian, go. What do you say about the Bears and Drillers in 90?
Well, I'll tell you, you know, that year at 90, Auburn was a very tough team. They were real scrappy. They hit you hard, and they were well coached. And the one thing that we had, we only had a 7-team league then. We didn't have the Centennials and Liberty, so I think the teams were able to be a little bit deeper. And when you played Arvin, especially at Arvin, you knew they were going to bear down on you, so you had to come out and be prepared to play. And, you know, fortunately for us that year, we were able to come out on top and stay undefeated.
Well, it's going to be short. Brings up a fourth and one for the Drillers. That 90 team, Hernan Santiago in the backfield, Lloyd Kennedy's the QB. Edgar Meres, the coach now, is playing against you and Jason Oliver and
Chad
Brian
Saul, Brady
yeah.
Beck,
oh my
David
goodness.
Hinn out here, he played.
What a squad. What a game that must have been. And did you score against the Bears?
Yeah, I was able to score that game.
Fourth and one. Drillers on the Liberty 28-yard line. And we've got a stoppage of play. And Coach Provencal now, the defensive coach, along with being the head coach, comes out. And he wants to talk about some things. And, man, he's got a serious walk, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does. And you know, and he's one of the most intense teammates I had in high school. I mean, Chad.
Really? Tell me about Coach Provencal as a player.
Intense in practice. And you know, he's one of those guys that loves football, loves to know why things work the way they work. And his intensity, I think, has been rubbed off on his team at Liberty the last 2 years. You know, he's a ferocious competitor.
What position did he excel in?
He ended up playing running back our senior year after we lost James Allison to graduation. But his trade was linebacker, and I tell you, he and Brady Beck are two of the best linebackers that I can say that I've seen in this area, that I've seen. You know, there's other players that I haven't seen before, but that I've been able to see in doing these games. I don't think there's been a combination of two inside linebackers like them.
That's the voice of Brian Adams, who played with Provencal at BHS. So you say he was an inquisitive football player, wanted to know the machinations of things and why it happens. Well, I'll tell you what's happening here. Fourth and one with 3:04 left in the half. Drillers on what I think is a keeper for the first down, and the young quarterback, Jake Scritchfield, showing about as much poise as one young quarterback can have, first time up in the bigs.
Yeah, it is. You know what? I tell you, fans, when it's that short, that's one of my favorite plays.
Sure
you
is.
Get up, you just snap it quick to the quarterback, and you go. And I don't know why more teams don't try that on those short fourth downs.
Earlier in the year, we watched a game out at Centennial against Edison, and you had even said, we watched Edison have a chance to have a real integral first down in the first part of the game. You know, sometimes, Vance, coaches overthink. First and 10, 2:40 left in the half. Drillers. Ooh, goodness. Well, Stewart got hammered. The ball was fumbled. Scritchfield jumped on it. Liberty shows their football, and the referee says second down BHS. So pretty heads-up play by everybody, Liberty and the Drillers.
I tell you, you know, Scritchfield, he goes out, does his play fake, and then he's ever alert, watches the play. I mean, his quickness to get to the ball was amazing.
Well, we're going to see our Rusty's replay here. Boom, what a hit.
You see the hit and the ball's coming out. We'll just see Scritchfield just dart through your screen right there and be able to save his team from losing the ball and keep in possession.
Zachary doing with the big hit. Second and 11. Liberty shows blitz. Oh, Scritchfield has a man out there. Underthrows him, just not enough zip on it. And Liberty defense starting to step up now and do what they need to do.
Well, I think what helped Liberty was that timeout, and they got a chance to rest, and plus that the helmet. So they were able to recover their breath, and now they're able to put some pressure on again. And that play was just forced because the defensive end comes off the outside and doesn't let Scritchfield get a chance to get rid of the ball. You see right there, there's no way he can get through with the pass.
His arm got hit. Kern County, this brings up third and 11. We are exactly at the two-minute mark left in this first half. Drillers lead by 8, 14-6 on the road out on the northwest side of Liberty. Up the middle, Scritchfield keeps. He throws. He's got a man open. He throws across the middle, and another poor pass by Scritchfield. Just not accurate.
Well, they've been poor the last few times, man, because he's getting hit when he's trying to throw. And I don't care what level of quarterback you are, whether it's peewee or pro, you're getting hit when you're trying to throw. You're not going to be accurate. And the other thing is, his receiver kind of slowed down, too, and didn't keep running for him. You got to keep busting across the field when you get that man-to-man coverage.
Great point, Brian. I was watching the receiver. I didn't see the quarterback get hit. Thanks for filling me in there, bud. Hey, just under 2 minutes left. Fourth and 11. Here come the Drillers again. They're not going to go for the kick. They're going to go for it. And I mean it being a long first down. Cooper in motion. Scritchfield lobs one up. This one's going to be up for grabs. Oh, goodness. In and out of the hands of Darnell Worthy. It should have been 6. It's not. It's first and 10 Liberty, and this entire Liberty crowd just went, oh.
Yeah, they did. They blew a big sigh of relief. They saw their defensive player slip, and Worthy didn't come down with the ball. So, again, when Scritchfield had a chance and time to throw it out being hit, he's put some nice balls up there. And this, what I like about this is Worthy 6'5". He's giving his guy a chance to catch. You see the slip. And Worthy just cannot bring it in. It hits him in the hands and bounces off and turnover on down.
Well, that's great coverage by our Bright House Network television crew. Thanks, fellas. Great shot. And if there's anything that Liberty needs right now is one last chance to get in the end zone here at half. First and 10, Patriots on their own 25-yard line. Fontana fakes right, rolls left. He might be in trouble again, and he is. He's thrown down at about the 24-yard line, and as much as we've talked about this big offensive line for the Patriots, Brian, there's been some sketchy activity out there in the trenches.
Well, I tell you, we got to give a check so far in the first half for Coach Crow, defensive coordinator, because he's going to bring Ross off the end. He's the strong safety. That's a strong safety blitz. Does a good job of coming in, forcing him to come up, and then early puts the big hit on and tries to strip the ball.
Wow.
That's Diaz right there. That's Daniel. I'm telling you, those Diaz cats, boys, man.
Hey, Kern County.
They'll put a hit licking on you.
Sometimes in your living room, I think that you've noticed by now that I'm far more of a fan than I am an announcer. You know, I make some noises sometimes because you just can't help it. Yikes.
I mean, that's just you dream of those the night before a game if you're a defender. Please let them not see me catching. He's trying to catch a pass so I can just light them up.
That was Kenneth Berman taking a hit from Daniel Diaz, and our fellows in the Bright House production truck also with a big Well, these young players can take it. They're studs.
Well, I'm gonna tell you, and I give Berman a lot of credit for catching the ball. A lot of players, they start hearing those footsteps and they'll just kind of let the ball go and get those little alligator arms, but he stuck in there and did a great job of making the catch and securing the catch.
Alligators not known for their long gangly arms, so they suck them in. We're under 1 minute, 59 seconds to be exact. The Patriots are at home. They have the ball. It's third and 22. The scoreboard says second, but our field says third. It should be third and 22. It is. And there's Kirk Boyer.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what Coach Boyer does because, you know, usually the coaching book says you run a little draw play and just keep field pushing to punt the ball, but we'll see what happens.
Big play for the Patriots. Fumble. Ball hits the ground. Fontana picks it up, throws it across the middle. Jay Williams with the catch. A nice, nice play. About a 19-yarder, 18-yarder, and that brings it up to a fourth and four and a half, and that's exactly what the doctor ordered for Liberty because now they can take a shot at it. Clock is ticking. We're at 30 seconds left in this half. Liberty trails by 8. Now there looks like confusion. The clock is ticking. There's not been a timeout. Fontana looking for the call. 21 seconds, 20 seconds. I'm not 100% sure, Brian, what the deal is here.
They're probably going to take the penalty and then move the ball back and then punt the ball.
Got it.
Only give them a little bit of time left.
Got it. It just looked like their momentum was like, hey, let's go for it. But obviously not. They want to get rid of this thing and go in only down 8. Well, so there it is, 9 seconds, Brian, 14-6. Before we go to halftime break, we have a split second here to talk about your thoughts about this first half.
Well, I think the first half has been defensively dominated. 2 touchdowns by the defense, and then the Drills were able to get 1 big play by Gordon down the sideline, and then run by Mason. But this is what we expected, defensive balance, what we're seeing. You know, and I heard a fan, Vance, down there yell, you know, come on, let's play some football. But Coach Provencal played it right there. You're taking the chance to get a first down. You didn't get his third down, fourth down. You don't take a chance on turnover and downs with running the ball, with running the play with 33 seconds. It's an incomplete pass. They only need to go 20 yards to get in the field goal range with time on the clock and timeouts for the Drillers. So that's the proper way to play it. You run the clock down. You punt it with as little bit of time as possible. You don't let a big return go down. And then you go in at half, you regroup and say, hey, we're still in this game, fellas.
That's the voice of Brian Adams explaining exactly what needed to be explained. But, hey, that fan paid his dosh, and he wants to make some noise. Maybe if he's watching Bright House Networks tomorrow morning, he'll get the hint. The punt is up, and another interesting punt. This one rolls really, really well, though, and gets to about the 33, 34-yard line, and it's perfect. The clock finishes. Hey, what a ball game. I'm Vance Palm. I've got Brian Adams next to me. You're watching Bright House Network's exclusive high school football game of the week, brought to you by the law offices of Young Woldridge, KERN 1410 News Talk, and, of course, Rusty's Pizza. Back in a moment with marching bands.
Some things can't be built in a day. Things like honesty, dedication, good hard work, and integrity. Since 1939, the law offices of Young Woldridge has had one of the strongest personal injury teams in the entire Central Valley. Today, that team is stronger than ever before. Through the years, our attorneys have won some of the highest dollar personal injury verdicts in Kern County. Put our experience to work for you. The law offices of Young Woldridge. Integrity you can trust.
Does this happen in your house?
Hey, Dad, where are those videos from last year's birthday?
Hallway closet. Taking up all the room.
There is a brighter way. Bright House Network's duplication services can help you edit all those home videos into your own personal family blockbuster. And when you're done, put it all on DVD so the memories will last forever. Bright House Networks also makes it easy to duplicate, repair, and transfer video to any format. Call today. Your memories are worth it.
101.5 KGFM, your station for continuous soft rock favorites. Listen at work.
I can feel you breathe, washing over me, and suddenly I'm there.
Listen at home.
Something about the way you look tonight.
Listen in the car.
Meaning of being
the artists you know, the songs you love. 101.5 KGFM.
Go in there, Robert.
You may take the field for your performance.
Kern County, welcome back. Week 7, Game 7. This is Vance Palm alongside Brian Adams. We're at the break here, having a nice conversation with Mr. Hurst from the Bakersfield, California, covering this big game tonight. Appreciate all his hard work here in the community. And here is the Liberty Patriot Marching Band. Let's watch the halftime show. We'll be right back.
the end of this quarter. We'll be right back.
You guys hungry?
Rusty!
Oh, he breaks from the pack and heads for the phone.
Give me the phone.
No.
Uh-oh, trouble from the sibling. What's he gonna do?
No.
Oh, look at that. He's doing the frantic finger dash. Let's see that in slow-mo. Nothing can stop him now. Look at that. Rusty's Pizza, on time every time.
Yeah!
Some things can't be built in a day. Things like honesty, dedication, good hard work, and integrity. Since 1939, the law offices of Young Woodridge has had one of the strongest personal injury teams in the entire Central Valley. Today, that team is stronger than ever before. Through the years, our attorneys have won some of the highest dollar personal injury verdicts in Kern County. Put our experience to work for you. The law offices of Young Woodridge, integrity you can trust.
101.5 KGFM, your station for continuous soft rock favorites.
Remember me when the west wind.
Listen at work.
I can feel you breathe, washing over me, and suddenly I'm there.
Listen at home.
Something about the way you look tonight.
Listen in the car.
Meaning of being.
The artists you know, the songs you love. 101.5 KGFM.
Networks presents the High School Football Game of the Week. Brought to you by the Law Offices of Young Woodridge, Rusty's Pizza, and KERN News Talk 1410.
Kern County Bright House Network subscribers, welcome back. We're about to start the third quarter. Brian, this game, we started talking early about the line and the powerful offenses, but it's been a defensive game so far.
Well, that's what I said earlier, Vance. It's going to have to be whose offense can come out, because we know both teams play good defense. And it was evident tonight because we have two touchdowns, one by Liberty on defense and one by the Drillers on defense.
Our first touchdown was a defensive touchdown. And, you know, as we talked about, Brian, already Aaron Yost started things off with a big run back.
Right.
And that kind of started
Liberty off, and looked like it could be a runaway. But I tell you, the Drillers came right back. Their defense tightened up, and they came back. Got good field position, and they turned around, punching a touchdown off a short run by Mason. And then all of a sudden, next play, Mike Stewart breaks on a little quick out and takes it to the house.
And that was the play that really, really galvanized this Bakersfield High School crowd. They started to think, hey, wait a minute, we really, truly are in this. And as we see Mike Stewart's interception and the great hands and the great concentration, I'll tell you what, these Drillers are back on target here, Brian. And you know they've got to be really excited here for the kickoff because they're receiving.
Yeah, they are. They're often need to get something going when they start this game.
Well, Kern County, we're going to hash on the replay. We're going to get right to it. The score, officially, 14 for the Drillers, 6 for the Patriots. The Drillers will receive. And we still have a ton of stuff to go over in the third quarter. High school predictions, we don't even have our predictions out. This game has been nonstop, action-packed. And you're watching Week 7, Game 7, Bright House Networks. High school game of the week. Californian had their game of the week down at Stockdale. Stockdale and West High School, that's a big game. This is a big game, and Brian, we'll have a chance to talk a little about predictions, but right now the Drillers really feeling good because now they get to do the receiving. Mason lets it go out of the end zone, first and 10 from the 20-yard line. Here's our replay that we were talking about in our just a few moments ago, and here's Mike Stewart's TD.
Yeah, Fontaine's going to step out and try to throw this little hitch, looks like to Williams. And Mike Stewart just jumps in front of it, does a good job breaking the ball, and right there with his speed, he's going to walk in.
First and 10 Drillers on their own 20-yard line. We're going to do some of our own predicting here in just a moment. First play of the third quarter. Critchfield, young quarterback behind center, throws the ball out to Gordon Cooper. Cooper can't handle it, and That might have been one of those instances where he's hearing footsteps, seeing some silver helmets in his vision there, you know?
Yeah, you know, right there, that's the play he made the big play on, Cooper did earlier on that play. Gordon did when he caught that one, took it down the sideline, almost scored, set that first touchdown. But again, you got to catch the ball when it's out there for you. But you never know when the quarterback's going to say, you know what, I'm not throwing anymore out that way.
Oh, goodness. Second and 10. Jake Critchfield behind center. First game for the varsity, and it's been a memorable one. Mason, about 4 or 5 yards, and Mason's a real, real nice runner. Brian, let's talk about West High School at Stockdale. Featured story today about the big lineman from West High and John Guevara, and he is taking his Vikings out to Stockdale tonight. Your thoughts, Vikings against Mustangs?
I think if the Mustang offense gets on track with the running game and then peppering in the passing game, I think they have the advantage because I think they play a little bit better defense. But again, West High steps up big in big games, and I wouldn't be surprised. I'm going to take West in that one.
Critchfield across the middle, just under through what might have been a reception for a first down out there to Matt Martin, but instead that brings up fourth and six, and just what the doctor ordered for this Liberty squad.
Yeah, and they're going to get a chance now to get the field position advantage and see if the driller defense can hold up.
Jay Williams, always dangerous. Been somewhat quiet tonight from the line of scrimmage. He's handled it quite a bit on punts, and we know from last year he's got it. Wow, another big booming punt. Backs up Williams to his own 25. He doesn't have a lot of room. He backs up, and he's brought down out there at about the 24-yard line. So great field coverage out there by the drillers, and holds that dangerous Jay Williams to nothing.
Yeah, and Jay's starting to get a little bit of frustration right now, and he can't do this. A lot of game left, you know, and Jay's like any good player, high school player, whatever. You want to make plays, you want the ball. But I think they have to get Jay the ball to deal on that last play before the half, across the middle, use his height and his size. Throw something up top, let him jump up and make a play on the smaller defender.
Height advantage hasn't been used truly.
Except for
the first play. And knowing that Jay's a hoopster, you'd think that would be in the mentality. Here we go, first and 10. Patriots on their own 25. Seriously want to get this offense clicking. Ball goes up the middle. Sorrell gets his usual 5 yards. It looks easy. We know it's not, but he just seems to always go forward, doesn't he?
Yeah, it does. I mean, like you said, Vince, it's only about 2 yards, and you look up, and he's picked up 5 or 6 yards. I'll tell you, Vance, I think the one thing that they have to do is get something going like that so they can get some time for Fontana, because he had no time at all, just like Scritchfield, when they're going back to drop back and pass.
Second and 4. Liberty trailing by 8 early in the third quarter. Fontana, hard count, nobody jumps.
Number 40, Berman, your ball carrier.
Berman gets maybe a yard, and
57.
Nice pursuit in there again by that driller defense.
Yeah, but I like that call again, because you got second and short. You had about 4 yards. You pick up another 2 yards. Now you got the whole playbook. You got play action. You got roll out with Fontana. So you can run or pass now to pick up this first down.
Third and 2. A big 2 yards here, and I mean metaphorically speaking, of course. 2 yards isn't that far, but this is a big play for the Patriots. Just under 10 minutes here in the third quarter. Oh, goodness. He's hit hard, and he's fumbled. Will the drillers get it back? No, they don't. Fontana falls on it, and an unfortunate slip up there. Patriots have to boot the ball just when they seem to kind of be getting things going, Brian.
Well, you know, they try to run the ball, and you're going to see excellent penetration. This is just a dive play. And I'll tell you, Vance, when you get in penetration like that, looks like Big Daniel Calvin, that dive play is not going to go anywhere. And Fontana did another heads-up job of a quarterback being alert and saving the turnover.
Well, Mike Stewart's had a big night already. His dad played for the Rams, the Dolphins, Fresno State, BHS, and he's back at the 40-yard line. Here's the punt. The Patriots looking for a good punt. They're going to get a nice bounce there for sure. Stewart fields it. And not a big hit, but certainly that was inevitable.
Yeah, that was great coverage right there by Lurgo right there. He did a great job of coming down and staying under control, breaking down and making a tackle.
Centennial Golden Hawks at South tonight. Arvin legend Coach Chamberlain said today, Vance, I honestly think Centennial, in my own opinion, this is his opinion, and I trust it, Centennial looks really strong this season. What do you think about them at South right after this play? First and 10, BHS. Fake pitch. Across the middle. Goodness gracious. Worthy having trouble tonight grabbing things, and he's got to be frustrated out there.
Yeah, Worthy's having a rough night catching the ball. That's another ball that's hitting right there. I mean, you can't ask the quarterback to do much more than that. You know, he's going to settle down and make the play.
Well, Worthy has all the tools. He's 6'5", 230 pounds. He's a senior. Yeah. Let a touchdown get out of his hands, and now here's a big first down, could have been, and I'm sure he'll regroup and say, hey, give me one more shot. Give me one more shot, young Jake. Second and 10, Drillers. After this, we'll get your thoughts on the Golden Hawks versus the Rebels. Critchfield now starting to show the poise and leadership of a senior, bringing his guys in. He's got Matt Martin in motion. Critchfield across the side, throws out there, and oh my gosh, Gordon Cooper lets one slip through his hands, so... Hey, for this young quarterback to step up and make these big throws, you would think that some of these cats want to help him out. Well, I know they want to, but you've got to will yourself to make these catches, Brian.
Well, I'll tell you, that's three drops we've seen in the second half, and I'm going to tell you, you know, again, the quarterback's putting the ball. He can't catch the ball, fans. I mean, he's throwing the ball out there, and he can't catch the ball. You know, Coach Oliver and staff, Brian Walker, they're working the offense, and they just have to make plays right there. I mean, there's not much you can do. It's just a simple pitch and catch.
Third and 10, just over 9 minutes left in this third quarter. Got still have people coming in. It's a big ball game. Mason takes the pitch out right. Got some nice blocking, well executed from this line, and Mason wills himself up to almost the first down. Takes a big hit too. Man, he took a pop.
He's got the first down.
They're moving the chains, Kern County. First down.
You know, and again, that's just your situation. Other than the pass defense, you call a little toss sweep. This is the athlete making a play right here. It's really not much there. He's just going to run through some tackles, jump over a hole, and watch this. He just drags the guy. I mean, this is his will to want that first down, like you said, Vance, and take a big hit right there.
Wow. Jared Seymour came in and did a final little pop on it, but not before Matt Mason, and he's been chewing up yards. I'd really like to know how many yards he has so far. First and 10, Drillers. This time the ball's caught. Matt Martin makes a nice play after the catch. So Scritchfield throws a little bit behind his receiver. Doesn't matter. Matt Martin said, hey, I'm not dropping this one, big fella. We're rolling down the field with it.
And that's what a receiver does. Matt Martin made an adjustment. He missed one earlier where he had a drop because it was thrown behind him. He didn't stop and catch. This time he secures the catch. Now becomes a runner. Oops, watch out now. That's a duck under you, and I'm going to pick up a first down. And like always, being aggressive, puts his head down and smashes for a first down.
Centennial at South tonight.
Centennial. Without a doubt.
Californian has it tight, 28-27. Eric Alford, player of the game last week.
It won't be five touchdowns on Centennial, I can tell you that right now.
Brian Adams.
And I like Eric. I call him Mr. Electric, but it's not that defense.
Adams comes in heavy. 8 minutes left in this third quarter. The pass was intended out there for Martin. He led him just a hair. Yeah, I happen to agree with that. I think that Centennial... just pretty sound football squad.
It's two different breeds of defense. One thing about North High that we do know is they play subtle defense. I don't think they strap it up and really take out a team, take the offense out completely. Centennial will take your offense out. So I think that's the difference.
Great point, Brian. Second and 10 for the Drillers. They're on the other side of the 50-yard line. They are at Liberty's 46 in motion. Sean Jansen. We've got flags. We've got whistles. What do you say, partner?
That's on the receiver. That's going back 5 yards against the Drillers. And you know how I feel about a receiver doing advance.
Brian, as a big-time receiver in DB, what are your feelings about that?
Receiver has no business ever false starting. Ever. Because, first of all, halftime you can't hear the call anyway because you're so far out. Second of all, you work all in the beginning of the camp and in the summer. When the ball moves, you move.
The other night,
that's just one where that's at, especially this time of year, that just can't happen.
The other night I'm watching Monday Night Football, Al Michaels and John Madden. John Madden said the same thing, and I started grinning. I said, told my wife, I said, well, honey, that's Brian right there getting all over the receivers. And you're right, 7.5 left in the third quarter, 2nd and 15. Scritchfield drops back, throws it across the middle. No flag. Great play out there. Anthony Haynell really hit him hard, and now we've got a Liberty Patriot down on the 42-yard line of Bakersfield High School, and looks to be in pain, and that's Shane Hawkins out there. Shane Hawkins in pain. Here's our Rusty's replay. Let's see.
And this play, look, it was doomed from the beginning. It just kind of started funny, but right there, oh, that's close. That's real close. You got to give it credit. Great play. Safety timed it perfect.
Intended out there for Sean Jansen, and a nice hit out there by Anthony Haynelt, and We do have a player down. It's Shane Hawkins, a 6 foot, 205-pound senior. Here's our play in our.
What we're going to see right here is the contact. Just timed it up perfect.
Great play out there by Haynelt.
Yes, it was. Timed it perfect. It looks like it's just cramps, man, so it doesn't look like it's going to be too bad of an injury.
Brian, your verbiage, I think, is spot on, perfect. If he's a hair earlier, it's going to be interference.
Yeah. Like I said, this is a great timing from the safety and great play, and you force a third and long, which I don't think BHS has had much, if any, success on third and long.
East High School Blades, the offensive locomotive, Leandre Matthews, against Foothill.
East High. I was just thinking about it. I was just thinking, you know, I guess, you know, it's not like we pool for teams, but, I mean, if it's a team you would like to see get a win and do well as Foothill, but I just think East High with Leandre and the big guys on the line is just too much.
Third and 15. Pretty big play here in the meat of the third quarter. 7:26 left in the third quarter. Third and 15, driller ball. Fake pitch. Crutchfield in trouble. Gets out of it. Launches one up. It's another nice, beautiful spiral. Again to Worthy. And Worthy not able to come down. But, of course, a little more traffic this time. Defensively out there, Brian Pennington. So, well, you have to say this for Crutchfield and the offensive coaches. They're still going after Worthy.
Yeah, and I'll tell you, too, the offense, they haven't completed the passes. But we watched the field game. The passes are there. There's an instant replay right here from Rusty's. And a good job of getting the ball up. And he knows he has an advantage with a 6'5 receiver. And his man has a chance to get it. Just can't pull it down. Good defensive play there by Pennington.
Here's the punt to Jay Williams. Jay Williams. Well, there. I'm wondering if there should be a flag. And Coach Provencal is saying, hey, wait a second. My guy's a superstar receiver that probably could have ran that thing, and you got your guy down in it. Well, either way, it was downed by the I mean, I'm kind of confused on this because he didn't call fair catch.
No,
so.
And I thought you kind of had to give the guy a chance, but maybe it has to be in the air once it's on the ground. I'm not sure about that. I don't think I've seen that play.
Well, Kern County, you heard it from Brian Adams, and if he doesn't know, I sure don't know.
But we'll get I'll get it for you next week.
Thank you.
If not tonight.
Thank you. First and 10, Liberty ball. On their own 8-yard line. Fontana drops back, looking across the middle. He's got Jay Williams, and oh, goodness, Jay Williams had a ton of territory. If he comes down with that one, right on the money, nice pass.
But I like the play. The big target across the middle. He didn't make the play on that one, but I would come back to it because he will make that play.
There you see 14-6 is the score. Patriots scored early, and I mean early, within the first couple minutes of this ball game. Aaron Yost ran one back, an interception, TD. They missed the extra point, but then BHS comes back and scores two immediately. Second and 10, Patriots still on their own 8-yard line. 7:04 left in the third quarter. Fontana.
Number 40, Berman, the ball carrier.
Hands the ball off again to Berman. Berman rolled out and rolled down, maybe even lost a yard.
And a flag on that outside.
Laundry on the field.
Far side from us, Vance. That's probably a holding.
With number 40,
it is holding against the Patriots, so add salt to the injury here, and that marches them back even further. That's going to be almost on the goal line, Brian.
Yeah, if they're inside the 10, they'll put it half the distance.
You're watching Bright House Network's exclusive high school football game of the week. We'd like to thank the law offices of Young Wooldridge. Tonight's choice could be awfully difficult, the athlete of the game for the Young Wooldridge Law Firm. And then, of course, Rusty's Pizza. I'd sure like to have a pizza right now. I think I'm going to call and order when I get home. Watch this thing and hear what Brian has to say. And then, of course, KERN 1410 News Talk. Big play for the Patriots. Way out here right is Sean Jansen. I mean, he's way out here. And it's 6:45 on the clock, 3rd and 11 Patriots. Fontana drops straight back, looking for Jansen across the middle. Might have overthrown him. No flag on the play. Jansen wants it.
And the reason why you're not going to get a flag is because he has just as much right as a receiver to play the ball. And what he did a good job is he turned his shoulders and he looked for the ball. Some defensive backs just keep running and they don't do anything. But he has just as much right as a receiver.
Well, we see Jack Ross, the DB over there, kind of giving a little lip service to Jansen. And then here's our long bomb here. And, wow, what a nice pass. Just not there. Oh, that was Scott Wells. Sorry about that. Scott Wells out there intended. And a nice, nice play out there by Matt Mason. Patriots punt deep in their own territory. Got to be a good snap. A perfect snap. Almost blocked. It's not. Not a bad punt. It gets out. Mike Stewart's going to field it. Can he get a good bounce? He does. Can he make a move? Not really. So it'll be first and 10 from the Liberty 49-yard line.
But again, Vance, Liberty is playing dangerous with this defense. Short field. You just can't keep doing that because sooner or later something's going to happen and they're going to break through. And I'm going to tell you, it's a penalty against the Drillers right there.
Ah. Liberty and VHS compounding things here with some of these injuries that they certainly don't need. And, Brian, you know, if you're Coach Oliver and the entire coaching staff, if you'd have told him as we watch our Rusty's replay, if you're thinking, hey, you're going to start 90% of your possessions tonight, you know, at least on your own 45-yard line, how does that sound?
Oh, he'd take it in a heartbeat.
Who wouldn't?
You know, because the thing is, even if you don't score, you can continue to pin your team, the other team, the opponent, inside the 20. So, but they're going to have to produce something. I just think they can't keep doing this because Liberty has enough power to score two or three real quick ones.
Liberty show blitz up front. Mason continues to move forward. Mason's still running, gets about 4 yards, and this Liberty crowd wanting to get into it, starting to get into it, starting to make a little noise. They can sense that, hey, you know, it's not as if we've been knocking on the door lately. We're down 8 points here.
Well, I'll tell you, you talk about the fans getting into it. The only way they're going to really get into it is the players have to get them into it. They have to make some big plays like they did the first interception by Jones. But, Vance, again, this defense cannot stay out here for the next quarter and a half and expect to win this game.
Second and 6, Drillers on their own 46-yard line. Scritchfield.
22, Mason, the ball carrier. Left by number 56 for the Patriots.
Hands the ball out to Mason, and this Liberty crowd starting to say just exactly what you said. Fellas, you give us the reason to cheer, we're going to cheer.
And that's what you need to do. Great penetration, no gain on the play. That's what you have to do, but I like the fact that the defense is staying aggressive. But right now, somebody on that offense, in that receiving core, has to step up and make a play when the ball gets out there. Because Scritchfield has, like I said, when he's had time, getting them opportunities to make plays, and they just haven't been able to do it.
Bakersfield High School having a pretty good game. Scritchfield got the I formation. It's a fake. Liberty shows blitz. Pass batted down out there by the big fella, Corey Actis. And now this crowd's starting to show a little bit of love for their squad out there. That brings up a fourth down, and Drillers a punt, Brian.
And you got what you wanted. You got three and out, and you got the crowd in it with big plays. It weren't soft plays, a good, strong tackle on second down, and a knockdown pass on third.
Gordon Cooper with a nice punt. Hauled in out there by number 6, Anthony Haynelt. And again, decent special teams by the Drillers, and they stop it.
It looks like Ross might be a little shaken up there.
Looks like they have an injury timeout on the field.
And that's a big blow for the Drillers if it's Ross.
Oh. Well, as we have an injury timeout here, and Ross looks as if he is in some serious pain. Brian, we go from one big game to another, and this is a game that I've been hearing quite a bit about. Chuck Chamberlain, legendary Auburn High coach, said, I will be at this game, north at Centennial. That's going to be a big one. And your thoughts on this game?
I think Centennial's going to bring up the offense, because one thing we've seen from north, they can score with a lot of different weapons, whether it be the quarterback running, the running backs running, throwing the ball. So I think Centennial's going to have to get some offense going in that game.
Well, Brian, I really don't know what to make of that pick. I mean, I watched North last week with you, and they just seemed, just the uniformity of their offense and how everything was just clicking, clicking, clicking. They would just score, 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 score. So you're right. We know that Centennial has a rough defense and a tough defense, but at the same time, they better be able to match wits and match points with that star offense. That'll be a great game. Don't miss it next week, North at Centennial, and it's nice to see our VHS player up and walking off. That is Ross. You were correct, and always important to see them up and healthy.
Yeah, and if you're the Drillers, you want to see him back on the field because he's a spiritual leader on that defensive secondary. He makes a lot of plays come off the corner on those blitzes.
First and 10, Liberty on their own 24-yard line. Drillers, four up front, four in the box.
43, four in the back.
Wow. Look at that. Chad Sorrell pounds his way up the middle. Even after a big hit in there by Tim Wilson, he just kept on going. So he just, and I know guys never want to hear they're like their older brothers, but he runs a lot like his older brother Cole. Here's our Rusty's replay.
Yeah, and you're going to see Sorrell just blast at the middle. And this is why I said he had to have a big game, because he's the guy leading up that fullback, that dive play. When that dive play is going for the Liberty, it opens up everything else.
Sorry, that was Trenton Francis that came in with a big hit. But Sorrell prevailed. 4.5 left in the third quarter. Sorrell leans in. This time the driller defense holds its own, and this is turning out to be a real super ball game. You can just see the intensity starting to build on both sides.
Yeah, it is. And it's, like we talked about, defensive battle, we're seeing it. There's a lot of excitement in this defensive battle. It's not a boring one. We're seeing big hits, interceptions, run back for touchdowns, sacks on the quarterback, rush passes, quarterbacks getting knocked down. So it's been an exciting ball game in terms from a defensive standpoint so far.
We're under 4 minutes left in the third quarter. I'm Vance Palm alongside Brian Adams. It's 2nd and 7 for the Patriots of Liberty. Driller show blitz by the big fella. They come in. It gets picked up across the middle. Oh, goodness. Richard Ball lets the ball slip right through. And, Brian, I'd hate to think that it has to do with the number 80 on the jerseys tonight. Worthy and Ball.
I don't know, but, you know, I tell you, there's been a few balls dropped tonight by both quarterbacks, you know, who put the ball, like I said, they can't catch it too. So they're going to have to get some help from the receiving corps in this game. I think whoever's receiving corps can start catching the ball might be able to win this one, man.
3rd and 7, Patriots. McClintock in motion. Ball goes up the middle. Sorrell, oh, and he's going to be stopped.
Right short of the first down.
It depends on where this spot's going to be, and this judge, this
That's
line judge.
That's a generous mark right there.
Well, the line judge was right on it, and
it's going to be a first down, but I tell you,
we'll
I've seen some generous marks for both teams when the runners have gotten hit next to the down marker, first down marker.
Well, it will be a first down from what we can see. Here's our Rusty's replay, and wow, Sorrell takes one hit there, gets loose, but then takes a real big pop.
Right here he comes in,
pow.
And Francis did a good job of just dropping him.
Never know, could be a pretty decent spot. From where we're looking, if it's not a first down, I know the Liberty's going to go for it. And it is a first down, Patriots. We got a football game, Kern County, and it's a nice one brewing right here. Liberty trailing by 8. They missed the extra point on their first touchdown. And as Brian so succinctly and poignantly brought to our attention, sometimes it's those one-pointers that can make all the difference, not just by the point differential, but what you have to do to make up for it later in the game. 1st and 10, 3.5 left in the third quarter. They continue to pound it away. Sorrell, big hole up the middle. He's met at about the 40-yard line, 39-yard line, and yeah, they're making the tackles, but they're also paying the price. Sorrell really gunning for those DBs when he gets through the hole.
Well, I tell you, the big three had a big game. None of them have really played great yet, but Sorrell's the first one to step up. And right now, this is just straight power football. This is just saying, hey, guys, we're going to come and run down your throat. And obviously, Coach Provenceau and his staff got on that offensive line because they're starting to open some big holes now for the Patriots.
This line that we've talked about so often is now starting to show their mettle. 3 minutes left in the third quarter. On the 38-yard line of the Drillers, Liberty has the ball. Fontana now drops back, has receivers open. He launches with someone up again. This was to Richard Ball. Richard Ball did not catch it.
That's an easy call to play right there. He never turned around and made a play on the ball. Never made a play on the ball.
That's Trenton Francis we're speaking of, and yeah, he's a great athlete, and he's playing a great ball game. But if there's ever a DB that I'm going to trust, it's Brian Adams and his call here. First down, Patriots.
See, right here, his back's to the play. He's never making a play on the ball. They're going to call that every time. Every time they're going to call it. It's an easy call. You're out. When you're a defensive back, yeah, remember, it's like a receiver holding. You're out in front of everybody. It's an easy call to say. If he turns around and makes a play, he might even get an interception. All he has to do is turn his head, put his hand up. They never call it.
When you're out there running down that field and you're getting beat by your receiver, you've got a million things going through your mind, you got to remember the key fundamental things. 1st and 10, Patriots, under 3 minutes here. The ball up the middle to number 30, Benjamin Hicks. And Benjamin Hicks is wrapped up and brought back, but not before he picks up at least 6 yards. As you said, Brian, this offensive line for the Patriots starting to step up and earn the applause that they've been having all year.
Yeah, and I think that big play by Actus blocking that ball on that last defense stand has fired up this team. You see now, I mean, Ross is making the tackle 6-7 yards downfield. That front line from Beatrice to dig in, and if you're Liberty Patriot offensive line, you want the coach to keep calling these runs and keep smashing them. You want to keep smashing them.
Second and 13. Second and 2 with 2:13 left in the third quarter. Fontana hangs on to the count. Sorrell up the middle. Sorrell again, 4 or 5 yards. That's a first down, and some hard-nosed smash mount on the ground football by the Patriots, and that seems to be successful in a big way right now.
And I'll tell you what else is happening with the Drillers, man. They're blitzing right by the run. They're coming up, and they're blitzing. They're going full bore, and they're running right by them. You see right here, they're already in the backfield. So once you get to those first seven guys, there's nobody but secondary players. Now, I'm going to tell you, if secondary players are making a tackle, those are 7-8 yard runs, minimum.
First and 10 from the 11-yard line, so they can still get another first down if they need it. A minute and a half left in the third quarter. Fontana hooks up with Jay Williams, finally. And it pays off with 6 points.
They need to be looking to go for two now. They might try to take a chance of just kicking the PAT. They should be looking to go for two, get the game tied up. 14-12 is the score. 14-12 is the score so far.
Well, our score that we're showing on the screen is not correct, but it is 14-12.
And I'm going to tell you what I like, Vance, about that play. You use his height and his size. When you get a big receiver out there on a small corner, you want to slant him in because the DB cannot make a play on him, or you want to throw it up and let him go get it in the corner. You got two routes to go, and I'm going to tell you, I would go back to the same route and make him stop it again. Go one-on-one and use his size.
Two-point conversion. Fontana. Looking. Fontana tries to get in himself. Nope. He does not. Drillers hold.
That's why that PAT was huge.
That Bakersfield High School crowd up on their feet. They are loving the fact that they didn't get in, because the most obvious point, Liberty has to get in the end zone again somehow, some way, or get it through the uprights for a three-pointer.
You know, it was so funny because momentum switches so fast. The defense comes out, they make a big hit, block a pass, they get charged up, but then also, when you're on defense, you stop a two-point conversion, you can flip back the other way, and right there's just a slant right there to Jay Williams, who is one of the best receivers in the area.
Had a chance to talk to Adam Heron, lineman for the Liberty Patriots, last week. And Adam Heron, one of the linemen that are trying to protect here for Fontana, and Brian, he's in trouble.
Yeah, he is. And right here, look at Ross. He came out a little bit earlier with an injury, comes back in.
Wow.
And that's why he's so important for that Driller defense to be out there. He's a big-time performer in that secondary.
Jack Ross goes off the field with an injury, comes back on, and makes a big play. And as I was talking about Adam Heron was one of those players that went out to that football camp in Michigan with Leandre Matthews and some other players. And I had a chance to talk to him about his squad this year. And he goes, Vance, I'll be honest with you, we know we have our biggest test so far. With the Drillers. I mean, they lost to a Clovis squad earlier this season, but hey, a couple weeks later, that's forgotten about. Here it is, Driller football right at you.
Well, the one thing about the Clovis loss, yeah, it hurts you in terms of rankings in the Californian or in the state or in the valley, whatever, but it doesn't hurt you from winning your division, your league. You lose this game, you're looking at maybe losing your league.
Wow. A buck and a half left in the third quarter. Drillers will receive. Patriots about to kick off. It's up and it's short. Mason on the 10-yard line. Mason looking for some protection. Mason looking to cut up. Uh-oh. Great coverage by the Patriots. Gets about 7 yards on that return. I'm surprised he was even able to field it. They kick it right to one of their fastest guys.
Well, I tell you, I thought that was a questionable kickoff right there. They've been moving the ball. But what happened to Mason is the wall left him. The wall, I've seen this in a lot of special teams so far this year. Look, there's no blockers. That wall has to wait. You wait till he gets about 6-7 yards behind you, because you want to protect them. It does you no good to fire out and block people 20 yards downfield if the guys run right behind you and tackle the runner.
1:22 left in the third quarter. First and 10. Drillers.
Mason, your ball carrier.
Mason up the middle. Gets about 3 yards. Clock continues to tick. Again, Jake Scritchfield called up from JV to be quarterback tonight for this Driller squad, and he's handled the pressure just fabulously, Brian.
I think he's done a great job for the magnitude of this game and how he's performed. Again,
he picked up about 3 yards on the play.
You have to remember, he's had some balls dropped on him, Vance. It would have been big plays, but he's been a solid performer. You know, he had the one mistake early when he got hit and forced the pass he probably shouldn't have, but other than that, he's been pretty steady, and he's leading this team.
Second and 7. 42 seconds left in the third quarter. Scritchfield drops back. Throws it out to big Darnell Worthy. Worthy makes this catch, and now Worthy gets about 20 more yards. And if there was ever a time to quote unquote make up for a couple drops, man, that was a big catch, Brian.
I tell you, Vance, you know, Worthy's an impressive athlete with his size. He also has the quickness we're going to see right here as he goes out and pulls up in Rusty's replay. But watch Worthy turn field, and he's going to make a move, because one thing he knows is they don't want to tackle this big man. And the big man makes a guy miss and then puts his shoulder down and runs over a guy. I like to get the ball in Worthy's hands again.
6'5", 230. He's a senior. First and 10. Drillers, the pitch. Out to Mason. Mason trying to get outside.
Nice run. That's the situation with Mason right there, where he just has more speed than the guys that are pursuing him. I mean, because those guys are really running hard. He's just kind of gliding around and picks up about 4 or 5 yards on me. You see right here. You see the pursuit right there, and he's just gliding on him now. That's just because he's just that fast. And then he just dips in and says, hey, give me 5 on that one. And you know, Vance, he doesn't have a lot of yards. He's got 2 big runs called back.
Last play of the third quarter coming up. 2nd and 5. Liberty's got a ton of guys right in the box. Critchfield hands off to Mason. Mason cuts up field. Mason spins and rolls, gets the first down. That brings us to the end of the third quarter. You're watching Bright House Network's exclusive high school football game of the week. This is Vance Palm alongside Brian Adams. We'd like to thank the law offices of Young Wooldridge, KERN 1410 News Talk, and Rusty's Pizza. We'll be back with the fourth quarter. How could anybody not come back to this ball game? Drillers up by 2, and we've got a barn burner. Back in a moment with the fourth quarter.
That's the end of this quarter. We'll be right back.
You guys hungry?
Rusty!
Oh, he breaks from the pack and heads for the phone.
Give me the phone.
No.
Uh-oh, trouble from the sibling. What's he gonna do?
No.
Oh, look at that. He's doing the frantic finger dash. Let's see that in slow-mo. Nothing can stop him now. Look at that. Rusty's Pizza. On time, every time.
Yeah!
Some things can't be built in a day. Things like honesty, dedication, good hard work, and integrity. Since 1939, the law offices of Young Wooldridge has had one of the strongest personal injury teams in the entire Central Valley. Today, that team is stronger than ever before. Through the years, our attorneys have won some of the highest dollar personal injury verdicts in Kern County. Put our experience to work for you. The law offices of Young Wooldridge. Integrity you can trust.
Kern County, welcome back. There's the big man on the field, head official. And what a professional he is. He knows we need 90 seconds before we can get back in here. And hey, Brian.
They're experiencing TV timeouts. They don't get that usually.
First and 10.
I got some information for you, Vance, about the punt return. When we saw the Drillers grab it, once the ball hits the ground, the defense can go in and get it like that.
We're talking about the punt earlier to Jay Williams, where he looked like he was going to field it on the hop and take off, but the Drillers got down there and did it. Here we go, 1st and 10, beginning of the fourth quarter. Critchfield hands off to Mike Stewart. Mike Stewart gets about a yard. If you've just made it into the living room or the bedroom or the kitchen or wherever you're watching this game, it's the fourth quarter. The Drillers are up by 2 over Liberty. We are out on the northwest side of Bakersfield at Liberty. That's Vance Palm alongside Brian Adams. One of our media colleagues, Matt Hurst from the Californian, up on the tower with us. pensive. 11 and a half minutes in this ball game left, and this is a very, very big ball game for everybody. Scritchfield back across the middle, under throws, and Worthy tripped up, but it was an uncatchable ball, and possibly the ref just took that in consideration. That'll bring up third and 10.
Well, I tell you, Big Corey Actis is the reason why that ball wasn't completed. I'm telling you, when I'm looking at Scritchfield's ball, it's coming out funny. I've been watching. It's because of pressure. When he has time, he throws a nice ball. So that you got to give credit to that defensive line right there. They got the pressure they needed to force the ball to get go out of his hands early. You see right there, he's being wrapped up as he's throwing the ball.
Well, Kern County, Corey Actis is number 78. He's 6'5", 270. And he's got maybe carte blanche on where he wants to go next year as a freshman. Sean Jansen in motion. Third and 10 for the Drillers. They're on the 44-yard line of Liberty. Fake pitch. Scritchfield throws it up, and this might be in trouble. Oh, goodness. To be quite frank with you, it should have been picked off by Jared Seymour.
Yeah, it did, but you know what? The Drillers can't afford to come up empty. Like I said earlier, they've had the field position in their favor. They've had to put some points on the board, and they haven't done it. And the big three are starting to roll offensively. You see right here in the rest of the replay, again, pressure again. He wants to throw the ball early before he's ready. And it just doesn't get down, and like I said, barely misses the big play of the interception, but it would have been like a punt anyway if he'd have caught it.
True. So. Cooper with a nice end over end, and it might bounce into the corner. Let's see what happens. Does it go out? Oh, goodness. If there was ever a chance to get it in the corner, there it is. That just outraces Jack Ross, and that'll be first and 10 on the 20-yard line for the Liberty Patriots with 11:08 left in this ball game. There's a great shot of that Liberty crowd. They really aren't sure if they should be up cheering to get them going or if they should kind of hold their wits and their thoughts about them. If I were them, I'd be up screaming and cheering right this second.
Well, you know, I think they will. As soon as they start, if the big three continue to roll, they'll start cheering real quick. But right now, if you're the Driller offense, you got to get on the sideline and figure out what you're going to do, put some points on the board. And defensively, you got to do something to stop Chad Sorrell from just running through your line at 6-7 yards a pop.
Fontana.
Number 43, Chad Sorrell, your ball.
Hands the ball off to Sorrell. Sorrell again gets about 2 or 3 yards. I don't know if he's been thrown for a loss yet tonight. Maybe once or twice. Always moving forward.
I think he got hit earlier.
Right, right.
That was just the one time he's gotten hit. And I think he still got to the line of scrimmage, man. I think he was hitting the backfield, but I think he still fell the line of scrimmage. But look for Jay Williams and Fontana on this play right here.
Sorrell, 6'1", 210 pounds. He's a junior. Look for Chad Sorrell's name all over the place this year and next. 10 and a half left in this ball game. Patriots trail by 2. Again, Sorrell the carrier continues to fight guys off. This time he's met with a bunch of Drillers up there at the front. You know, Cole Sorrell, his older brother last year, came into that big game at BHS to step in for Horace Berger, who couldn't play. And Sorrell, in my opinion, had one of the most phenomenal nights, just running guys down as a linebacker. And then carrying the ball, I think he carried the ball over 20 times for 100-something, 180 yards. He was obviously our young Woolridge athlete of the game and kind of set the bar for his brother, didn't he?
Yeah, he did, but it looked like his brother's following suit because he's playing that same linebacker position and running the ball nice tonight.
Way to go, Chad. Liberty, 3rd and 5. Important 3rd down. Fontana drops back, looks for Williams. Oh, he's hit right as he releases, and about as big a play as you can have for that Driller defense.
Yeah, it is, and you know what's funny, man, so we talked about defensive game tonight, but both defensive lines have come up with big plays on the quarterbacks and forced them to throw the ball early. You see right here, Wilson to come around, does a good job of hitting him as the ball's coming out, and Fontana has one squirt to the ground because he had a man open.
Wow, nice autumn breeze swimming across the Kern River, coming right at us. I need my sweater, Brian.
I hope you didn't bring it.
4th and 5. Liberty's got the punt. Looked like motion on the right tight end out there, and it is for Liberty. And just back it up 5 more yards. But Mike Stewart gets to walk up about 5 or 6 more yards. And he's standing about the 48 to 49-yard line. And if we can get a shot of Mike Stewart, he's standing right at midfield. Wow.
And I'll tell you, man, the reason why it's big, too, because, you know, Gomez has almost had a couple of punts blocked. And he really hasn't punted the ball, got some really nice booming punts off yet.
Mike Stewart's at the 45-yard line. There he is. He's waiting. Here comes the snap, the punt. It's up. It's a nice boot. He backs up Stewart. Stewart's backpedaling. Stewart Might try to pick it up, and he does, but he gets it at the 27-yard line. Stewart,
return ball.
Can he get it? Gets a nice crackback block.
Ball.
Gets another. Oh, penalty flag called, and I guess it wasn't a good block. They might have called clipping. BHS crowd booing the refs. They're all over the refs on this. They thought it was a clean block, and wow, Brian Pennington just got shellacked out there.
Yeah, you know, and I know that the Liberty fans are calling it. Listen, we have to get a good look right here.
Only Bright House production crew will tell us if it is or not.
Yeah, instant replay, and Gomez does a good job of getting the boot on this one. And you're going to see Stewart trying to turn around. Let's see if we can get on our screen. From that view that we had, which was limited, it looked like he was hitting the back, but I could not tell totally. But referee called it. He's right there, and I'd imagine that he wouldn't miss it. So that's something the Drillers couldn't afford. And I tell you, Gomez picked a fine time to get his best punt of the night off.
Sure did get a nice punt. And as you say, from the view that we saw on our replay, nice call by the referee. Good job. 9:25 left in this ball game. Brian, you mentioned it at the break. The Drillers need to get in the end zone.
Yeah, they have to. And this is something that's a test for them as well, to see if they can actually put a drive together, sustain a drive, and drive the ball down the field.
Scritchfield rolls across the middle. Look out! Well, an interception, and then a fumble, and now we've got a flag.
Got a pass coming.
Who do you think it is?
It's going to be something. It's going to be something going on between the players, the way I would think. Some pushing and shoving.
Testing.
Well, for the record, Scritchfield rolled right, threw a bullet, but overthrew his receiver. Picked off in there. Brian Pennington makes the interception, and then there was some business at the end of it when the flag went up. And this is a big call right here, because if it gets the Drillers, it's going to be another 10 to 15 yards towards the end zone of Liberty. And if it gets Liberty, at least it backs the Patriots up a bit for some breathing space for the Patriots, for the Drillers.
Personal
Let's
foul,
see.
Drillers.
Wow, personal foul on the Drillers. Here's our Rusty's replay.
And you'll see right here, it just floated on, rolling to the right, gets over, good catch by Pennington. And then right there, Pennington does a good job of returning to an offensive player, making the guy miss, and oh, almost fumbles the ball there, but was able to recover it. And then I don't see what's happening.
Oh, goodness. I'm not quite sure what that flag is about.
Yeah, I'll tell you, you know.
Wow.
Maybe there's some other stuff that happened afterwards that we didn't see, but from what we saw, there was nothing that indicated it should be any kind of call going up there.
Liberty, first and 10, on the 10-yard line of the Drillers. Sorrell up the middle. He's wrapped up, and if nothing else, the Drillers knew that play was coming, and they met him.
And that's the first time he's got stopped in his tracks, too.
That'll bring up second and 10, and what a big, big play, a big interception by that Liberty defense, and the ball was thrown right to Pennington.
Yeah.
And now we're going to see what this BHS defense is all about. They've been strong all year. As you say, when their offense hasn't been clicking, they've had to really keep their teams close and give them wins when they could get them.
Yeah, they have.
Here comes a big, big challenge.
And that 15 yards is huge, because now you're in some decent field goal range, man, if you're able to stop Liberty and force a fourth down.
And they started this series on the 11-yard line, so they could get another first down. Jansen in motion. Fontana drops back, looks, has all the time in the world, throws out. Look at this, is this caught? It says incomplete. So it was intended out there to Richard Ball. Ball drops it.
No, he didn't drop it, man. It got dislodged from him. That's not a drop. That's just a good play by Jack Ross right here.
Here.
Richard Ball.
Fontana drops back. He knows he wants to go.
11,
and you're going to see right there, boom, there's the hit. This ball's dislodged.
Well, then, Brian, my question to you is, because the hit came a second later, shouldn't that be a fumble?
No, because he never has possession.
We got a timeout on the field, timeout Liberty. So Coach Provencal with a 3rd and 12 really wants to talk it over with Kirk Boyer. And they most definitely want to come up with a play that's going to get them at least right down in the neighborhood and knock on the door. If they don't get the first down,
they're talking right there, but I'm going to tell you what my play would be. I'd put Jay on either the weak side into the boundary and let him go one-on-one, either a slant, depending on where the defensive back is playing, or I throw the ball to almost where that cameraman is there in the corner and let Jay go up and snatch it. I would let my best two players have to make a play right here, and if they don't, I have to kick a field goal or whatever, but I'm going with my best two players right here. Nobody else is getting the ball.
Thank you, Brian. 8:22 left in this ball game, and we have had a great, great ball game. Bright House Network subscribers, when we throw these things up on the screen, a lot of times we're wanting you to call your friends and tell them to subscribe, but if you're already a subscriber, you need to know about this, the DVR, digital video recorder, pause and rewind live TV. Never miss another great play with a new DVR from Bright House Networks. You can rewind and pause live TV from your remote control. Call 323-4892 to order your digital video recorder today. On a game like this, Brian, first of all, they're going to call 322-1941 for this tape, but they also want the DVR. I want to see a big-time play. Third and 12. This is it, Kern County. 8:22 left in the ballgame. Liberty needs it. Fontana fakes and rolls right. He looks across the middle. It is overthrown. Incomplete. Really never had a chance. Great coverage out there.
Well, Jay Williams excited. He might have got off the double coverage, but I tell you, Coach Oliver and Coach Crow actually countered very good against that play. He lined up a guy over Jay Williams and took him out of the play with Tim Wilson. And that's what you do when you force him to go somewhere else, and Fontana just wasn't able to get the ball down. But it was good coverage. The driller was right there. So,
well, we saw Kevin Okarski making our first couple of kicks tonight, and now it's Andrew McAtee for a very, very big field goal to put the Patriots up. The snap, the hold, the kick, and it is going to be short. And to the right, this driller crowd is euphoric. Well, there's still 8 minutes left, but
they better get offensive real quick, Vance, or they could be looking at giving the ball back to Fontana and company and get them another chance to get down here and kick a field goal or score a touchdown.
Former driller Brian Adams says, no more euphoria. Let's go offense-minded football right now. Brian, I couldn't agree with you more. This Liberty offense, they've been clicking at times. I don't think they've been in full stride yet tonight.
Well, that's just credit to Coach Crow and his defense. I mean, they've made the plays they needed to make.
Mason gets the handoff. He's dropped for a loss, about 3 yards. Clock still ticks. And, Brian, where does the clock come in here as far as play calling and strategy?
Well, I'll tell you, if you try to run the clock out now with 7:55, you're going to run yourself into a loss. There's still too much time. You still got to be thinking about getting first downs, moving the ball. Again, I think the Drillers need to get a drive, not only to win tonight, but for their own confidence to say, you know what, we're more than just a big play team with two big plays. We get in an interception. We can move the ball methodically and make people and wear people down.
7.5 left in this ball game. Second and 12. Mason cuts up. Mason continues to run hard. He gets hit hard, too. Gets a gain of about 8 yards, and that'll bring up third and about four. Because Liberty High School has 31 cheerleaders and a mascot, and they need some help from their crowd right now.
And here's the instant replay right here, Vance, from Rusty's. And you're going to see Mason does a good job. They've had a lot of success with that stretch play, especially on the defense, letting him cut back and using the speed and quickness. But one thing, Vance, that I'll tell you, a team that does a good job of making these killer drives is Centennial. They are the best at it. Fourth quarter drive, they're the best at it year in, year out.
We'll be there next week, but right now, we're at Liberty, and their defense is looking for a big hole. Third and five. Wow. With 6:42 left, they try to go up the middle. Mason had nothing doing. Big stop by this Liberty defense, and Coach Oliver decided just to not take any gambles.
Well, I think that's what he was doing. You know, his young quarterback has already thrown a couple interceptions, and he probably just was trying not to put him in a situation where he could turn the ball over, and he wants to punt the ball and let his defense win the game.
That's cool. Sorry to give the inside track. I was telling our longtime tower cameraman, John, up here, thanks for the warmth that we're getting from the light, Brian. You know, I see you shaking your head, chagrining, rolling your eyes, giving me
I can't believe this. He doesn't bring the sweater, people, and he uses the big light for heat.
You know, Kern County, I take a lot of action from Brian here. Brian's always trying to, I don't know, he just, see this right here, and it's warming me up a little bit. I spent a lot of years in the Caribbean, my man. I lived in Miami almost 10 years, and it's got to be at least 70 right now. And I'm from Army, can you believe it? Fourth and 7. Drillers will punt. They need a good one. Cooper has a nice spiral. D Dangerous. Jay Williams fields it. Ooh, he grabs it at about the 27-yard line. He's got some room. Jay Williams better protect that football. He gets up to midfield. Williams gives them very good field position. Gets up to the Drillers, 42-yard line. And that's exactly what Patriots needed right now, Brian, some good field position.
Well, that's what happens when you outkick the coverage. Those low, long ones, they look good on TV because they're kicked a long way. But you just have so much room to return the ball that the guys can't come down the lane. And remember, you're seeing Jack Ross. Ross is playing both ways. And you got guys playing both ways. They're tired of coming down, and nobody's able to tackle until he gets the ball to the 45. And again, I told you, it was too much time to get conservative.
Drillers D got to dig in again. 6:10 left in this football game. What a football game. Fontana to the left side. A big hole out there for number 40. Number 30. That's Benjamin Hicks, and Benjamin Hicks, just like that, brings the Patriots up to about the 26-yard line. And now this Driller defense is
instant replay. You want to call? You want to focus on Chad Sorrell? Cool. We'll go to our fullback on a quick dive, and he'll pick up 12 on you.
First and 10, Patriots. We're under 6 minutes. They've scored two TDs, missed both PATs. That's why they have 12. Fontana with a hard count. Out to Sorrell. Sorrell cuts up, then cuts out. He's met out there and brushes off another tackle. Wow, great running out there by Chad Sorrell. Sorrell up to about the 10-yard line. He brushed off a few tackles and kept running.
And I tell you, man, you know, Driller fans, you can't be mad at the defense. You ask them to do too much. You ask them to play too much defense. You're not getting anything from the offense. And this is what happens. They're tired right now. They haven't had the chance to rest. They're going three and out almost every series. And here's Sorrell just taking advantage of using his size and strength to just wear them down.
First and 10, Patriots. Looks like they may be inside the 10, or are they on the 10? They are exactly on the 10-yard line, so basically it's first and goal. Fontana up the middle, Sorrell. Sorrell is met early. Thrown for a 1-yard loss. Fontana walks over to the sidelines. What do you have, Brian?
I know they're having field goal problems and PAT problems, but I'm telling you, they're in range now. This is a chip shot. If they don't get any more yards, this is a chip shot, and it'll be a 15-14 game. But again, I would think they're going to go to Jay Williams sooner or later. He's the big play man. Fontana's the strong arm, and I would imagine they're going to look for him.
It's second and 12. Patriots have the ball with 5 minutes left in this ball game. This is serious stuff now. Fontana hands the ball off again, up the middle to Sorrell. Sorrell stopped again, not going far.
Yeah, Vance, right there, that's just a great job right there by the defensive line of BHS, tightening up and getting tough and force them into a third down situation.
Third down for the Patriots.
Wow, third and 10. 4:30 left in this ball game. The autumnal breeze shooting straight over here from Cal State Bakersfield. It's starting to get crisp now. It feels like a big time Friday night football game. Here it is, third and 10, I formation. Fontana has Williams way left. Williams splits across the middle, being well covered. Fontana has all night to throw. Now he's scrambling. He's got some room. He looks into the end zone. He decides to throw it up, and it's picked off.
And he's going the other way.
Look at this, Kern County. Sam Young. No, is that Yan Song?
No.
Sorry.
No, he's not. It's Diaz.
Oh, that's
Greg Diaz.
That's Greg Diaz.
Diaz.
Oh, Kern County, I apologize. We had known that earlier. Should have taken that name out, but Greg Diaz, oh, goodness gracious. He comes through with a huge play. And, Brian, your thoughts on this ball being released by Fontana?
Well, first of all, great protection and great coverage. Now, this is a stalemate right here. You don't get the sack. Fontana's a good athlete, gets outside. You know, he's a baseball player, has a strong arm. And right here, he's just trying to make something happen. And unfortunately, the pressure makes him get the ball up early, and he had a receiver, but Diaz gets there and picks it off. and returns the ball, gets Drill's good position. Now Drill's got to kind of get something going. They got to get some first downs, though, Vance.
Well, as you say that, we see laundry on the field before the play even gets going, so I can only imagine that's against the Drillers. And, hey, emotions are high right now, but you still don't forget the things you've been practicing since back in August.
No, and it's even more important now not to get the penalties. You know, you're just trying to get 10 yards, but now you got to get 15 yards. And you're really afraid to really get the ball and put the ball in the air. This is I think it's a good timeout by Coach Oliver, who is hot right now. I tell you, and a lot of people don't know Coach Oliver, but he's not one to get real emotional like that. But he is emotional and hot right now because those are just mistakes you cannot do. You get set and you go for it and you try to win this game because he knows that putting the pressure on your young quarterback right now might not be the best thing to do. And he knows he only needs maybe one or two first downs.
Well, we have two former Drillers out meeting with their teams. One is Jason Oliver, the head coach of the Drillers, and the other is Provençal, the head coach for the Liberty Patriots. So we've got two head coaches, both alumni Drillers, and there's Jason just saying, fellas, it's all about right now, execute. We can't afford mistakes like this. And I can guarantee you 3-2-2-1941 is going to be ringing off the hook on Monday, because people want this tape, 3-2-2-1941, for a copy of tonight's game. And there's Coach Provençal. Looks like a field general.
Yeah, he does. He has that steely-eyed look, no nonsense.
Here we go, Brian. First and 15. 3:58 left in this ball game. I formation for the Drillers. Throwing the football. Oh, goodness. Gordon Cooper should have had that catch, and that probably could have been a nice gain. What do you think of Scritchfield dropping back and letting him go? And we see Coach Oliver saying, goodness gracious, you got him off guard. You got to catch it.
That's two drops. And the worst thing about this drop is second and 15, but the clock, you only lost like 3 seconds.
You know,
there's no time off the clock. And Liberty's in a situation where you keep playing with this offense, they're going to make a play.
You know, the thought is he makes the catch, stays in bounds, gets 4 or 5 yards, but when the ball is dropped, clock stops. Jake Scritchfield, QB, hands the ball off. Number 33, Daniel Diaz. His brother, Greg Diaz, had a monumental interception a few moments ago. The clock is ticking, but that brings up third and about seven.
I tell you, Liberty defense has to hold right here, and they dodged a big blow at that drop pass. But Diaz does a good job of getting upfield. I also saw him work on this play, and Coach Sheehy said it would be there, and sure enough, it was right there on the Rusty's replay.
Who'd have thunk, Brian, after all this, that PATs would have played such a pivotal role, and this game's not over yet. 3:15 left in this ball game. Drillers, 3rd and 8. Biggest third down of their season so far. Scritchfield drops back. He's in trouble. Can he get rid of it? He spins. He's got nowhere to go. He pitches out to Mason. Mason looking for a block. Mason gets nothing. He's brought down.
He might have got a face mask. They didn't call it. I think the coach wanted the face mask.
Oh, goodness. VHS coaching staff all over these referees for what they thought was an apparent, obvious face mask.
Well, they got lucky on that one. I think it was a high tackle. I don't know if we'll be able to see it, but I saw the coaching staff grabbing for that face mask.
Scritchfield.
Scritchfield did a good job of getting away and says heads up on the Rusty's replay. He's going to pitch it right here. Let's just see if we can see anything coming through on Mason. They won that high tackle. It's close. Looked like it just might be on the shoulder pad, but it was close, but that's what the coach was screaming for.
4th and 11. Drillers have to punt. Dangerous, dangerous. Jay Williams back there fielding the ball. Now he gets out of the way. Well, bounces north, and the Drillers have to pounce on it, so Liberty has the ball on their 47-yard line, and that Driller fans has a look of, I think, all the Driller fans.
Oh,
come on,
seen this before. They lost, who was it, the Clovis they lost to, 10-7? Or Buchanan, which team they lose to? They lost to a team just like this. They were winning 7-3, and the team drove down and scored a touchdown on them, and it was Buchanan. So, you know, they've been in a situation before where the defense just didn't make the plays they needed to do in that last series. But, again, your defense is going to be tired when they're playing this many downs.
Well, we got a ton of stats up here. None of them really matter. 2:21 right now left in this ball game. It's all about heart and execution. Fontana hands the ball off to Sorrell, and Sorrell has truly become an incredibly integral part of their offense, Brian.
Yeah, he's just ground the ball out now. I mean, he's getting 9 yards a pop, 8 yards. They stopped him a couple times. But that's what you have to stop them, because they're going to run the ball, so the clock's going to be in your favor. You need to just make a stop. You need to stop them in the backfield.
We're under 2 minutes. The score, 14-12. Drillers lead the Patriots. Both of them 1-0 in league play. This could be the hill the Drillers need to get over, or another big, big victory for the Patriots. Fontana wants to throw. Looks across the middle, but this time he's launching it long. He's got ball open.
He dropped it. I tell you, I don't think we've done a game, Vance, in our time where we've seen so many balls dropped. And there's no bigger ball drop right there than ball. Nobody feels worse than that young man dropping the ball right there on a touchdown. You see the rest of the replay. Fontana gets the time, sets up, like the way he bounced off that back foot, puts the ball up. And this is 50 yards in the air. Puts on the money and just right through his hands. And I tell you, the Driller defense has to be real careful. Gordon Cooper, they can't get behind you.
Yikes. Third and one. I think if you're a gambling man, you can bet the house. Sorrell's running up the middle on this. Huge play. 1:37 left in the ball game. Not Sorrell, but oh, wow. Ben Hicks up the middle. They got the first down. Great play.
I tell you, Hicks did a great job of getting, that's just his effort right there, because he got hit short of the first down marker. But I think this is an easy first down, Vance.
Brian, at about this point right now, with a buck and a half left in this ball game, you've had two PATs missed, an attempted field goal missed if you're the Liberty Patriots. And now you're thinking, well, to jockey for field position here and to get ourselves in a spot where we can boot one through, your kicker's got to be getting ready too, mentally. And I don't see anybody on that sidelines kicking balls.
Well, I tell you, the funny thing about football kickers, when they're missing kicks, nobody really likes the kicker. When they're making them, he's your favorite player. And I can't see Coach Provençal not looking to try to score a touchdown. I don't think he's going to play for a field goal to win the game.
Brian, I agree. But if fate puts you in this position, don't you have a guy in the sidelines booting, getting warmed up, kicking?
Well, he got plenty of time. They're not even close to his range.
Very good. Very good. First and 10, Liberty. 1:21 left in this ball game. Drillers trying to put a stop on it. Fontana looks again. This time, he's going upstairs again. Not going to happen. No flags,
well,
not coming out. Wow.
It should have been one. It should have been one, and that's what some Liberty people are a little upset. I don't know how you don't play the ball. And Matt Mason is a great corner. He really is. And to play running back and corner is a tough double.
Brian, you got young DBs out there watching. Talk to them.
But you got to turn and make a play on the ball. I just don't think you should be able to just sit there. He never turns and plays the ball at the last minute, but they must be saying the ball's uncatchable. That's the only thing I can see him saying is the ball is uncatchable.
1:13 left in the ball game. Second and 10, Liberty at midfield. Oh, fumble! It's coughed up!
And the Drillers caught. That's the fumble they needed. That's the play the defense needed.
This crowd
they
is
got it. They
off
can run
the
it
hook.
Now, Vance.
They Bakersfield can run it out High School, sorry to talk over you. Bakersfield High School comes up with the biggest fumble recovery, I think, personally, in Coach Oliver's two-year career here.
Well, I think this is it, because this gives him the notch and having an advantage in the league. And I really don't see other teams in this league beating him in the rest of this year. But right here, he never has the ball, and the ball comes off his leg and kicks out. And then you're going to see the Drillers start scrambling for it. And I like how they just tried to cover the ball. They weren't trying to pick it up and run, and Gordon comes in and secures it right there. And it's going to be Gordon Cooper picking it up, but him and Jack Ross didn't try to make a running play. Just new possession was important.
Matt Mason tries to get outside. He's trying to just stay safe with the ball, but he almost broke one. Brian, the clock's ticking.
Well, they're going to call timeout. Liberty's going to call timeout. They're going to start using their timeouts.
While they've got this timeout call, there's a few stories here that I want to remind Kern County about if they've just started watching this game late. First of all, quarterbacking tonight for the Drillers. Young Jake Scritchfield played JV, gets called up tonight. This has to be one epic night for his young mind.
Yeah, it is. You know, and I'm going to tell you, the pressure on this game, you know, if you never played at this level of ball or been in it, you're never going to know, was tremendous. And for him to play the way he played, he performed well. He had some drop balls. Yes, he had two interceptions, two forced throws, but he did do a great job of putting the ball on some players. And he just had some drops, Vance, and he kept his composure.
Second big story tonight. Today's Bakersfield, Californian has Liberty 35, Bakersfield 7. Underneath it says the Patriots have too much offense. Tonight, Bakersfield defense really stepped up.
Well, I think what's happened is, Vance, and we talk about scores, is that Centennial beat BHS 21-0, but it was not a whooping, a 21-0 where they just dominated the game. They had some crucial plays, a fumble they turned over to a touchdown, a punt return by Putman for a touchdown, and then they had the miscue on defense where a man broke wide open and they scored on that one play. Other than that, Centennial did not do much against the Driller defense. Buchanan did not do much against Driller defense. They have played solid defense all year long, and I don't think they got enough credit for their defense.
Mike Stewart Sr., a couple weeks ago, when BHS played Centennial, was up here on the tower. We all had a nice chat, and the bottom line was, when Bakersfield gets their offense going, things are going to start clicking, like your Bruins. When the offense gets rolling, things start to click. Well, right now, the offense has done enough tonight, but this game's not over. 53 seconds left. You're watching Bright House Network's High School Football Game of the Week. What a game it is. It's 2nd and 3. And that's to Mike Stewart. And boy, you get hit that early, and that's near fumble material.
Yeah, it is. And I'm going to tell you, this is when you got – I hope Coach Oliver goes out and tells his team, hey, line, the game's not over, fellas.
Exactly.
We need 3 big yards. 4 now, probably 5 big yards.
You ever heard of a guy named Corey Actis?
But don't put the ball in the air if I'm coach. Hey, I take my chance on running it, and I run the clock down, take my 5-yard penalty. I punt the ball and give them maybe 10 seconds left or whatever. But they have to step and block. That's what he's telling them. If your coach – Provençal, Vance, you're telling them we need a turnover. We cannot afford for them to just run the clock down and try to punt it.
Well, we had a shot of some of these Liberty players on the bench over there sitting down, somewhat dejected, bummed out, and we saw Coach Boyer come over there and say, fellas, on your feet, over here in the sidelines, let's get it rolling. You got to stay in this thing.
And, Vance, you've been around sports a long time. Weird things happen. I mean –
Fontana's taking snaps from the shotgun.
Yeah, you never know. And as strong as his arm is, he can get the ball way down the field. And you know, get Jay Williams make a big catch. I mean, weird things are happening. If you think they don't happen, ask those Red Sox and Cub fans.
Oh boy, a pennant mention from Big B. 49 seconds, 3rd and 5. Everybody on the line for Liberty. They're looking to try to create some type of turnover, some type of fumble. And now the clock will tick. Liberty players running on the field as fast as possible. Jay Williams, that super talented receiver slash basketball player at the 40-yard line, he's now looking back at the sidelines, and the clock is ticking. Bakersfield High School, will they let it click and take the penalty?
Oh, yeah. Why snap it?
Well, Jay Williams up on the line, assuming that they're going to run the play now. I don't understand why BHS wouldn't take the penalty. I'm sure that they will. Gordon Cooper, the punter, calls timeout now.
Timeout Drillers.
So Gordon Cooper calls timeout. The Drillers have a timeout. Kern County, what a ball game. Drillers up by 2 with 7 seconds left, and this Liberty crowd is stunned. They're quiet. They're bummed, and they're leaving.
Well, you know, I tell you, they didn't expect it. I can pretty much believe they thought, you know, they were going to have a feast on the Drillers because the offense problems Drillers have and with their great offense. But again, you know, this game was a battle last year, went down to the wire, and it's the same thing again. And, you know, I think people have to realize what a great game these two teams have played. The score is not, for, you know, 25, 35, like the or 58, whatever it was with the North High team. But you saw two really good defenses lock up. When they've had to make some plays, Vance, they've come up with interceptions, touchdown returns, stops on third down. You know, you couldn't ask for more from these defenses and these coaches and their staffs.
Well, Jay Williams standing at the 25-yard line. Gordon Cooper will punt it, number 2 to number 2. Liberty's trying to go for the block, trying to go for the hard count. Cooper gets it up. It's a big punt. Williams takes it to the 30-yard line. 1 second.
Oh, it's over.
It slipped, and it's over.
No, we got 1 second left.
Oh, 1 second. But 1 second left. Sorry, he went down. Did he slip or did he go down?
He slipped, but you know what? Hey, you know
save
what I'm
the,
thinking?
That
they might have wanted to fair catch the ball and get the 7 seconds and get a chance to throw one up.
Yeah, I don't.
But they'll get one now, so. I'll tell you this, I'd have every man back down there if I was the Drillers. Right here, you're going to see him on return. And he wants to make a big play, and he's capable, but he just loses footing and slips. And it probably gave them an opportunity to make one play.
Can you believe it? He slips on the grass, and it gives the Liberty Patriots one final shot. The Drillers call a timeout.
Timeout, Drillers.
Hey, Kern County Bright House Network subscribers. Last night we did our final Mason Marin Inside Motorsports live show, and the October Classic is happening tonight. And if you're watching this on our encore presentation and it's Saturday morning already, get out to Mason Marin tonight, Saturday night. The late models and a Southwest Featherlight Tour. Dan Holtz, Augie Vidovich, Pettit, some big names. And then Sunday afternoon, how can you miss it? The super late model race, and then the Winston West, Lucas Oil 150, drivers like Mike Duncan, Portengay, Lynch. Big names out there. See you at Mason Marin this weekend for the 26th annual Lucas Oil October Classic. Brian, 1 second on the clock.
I tell you, Vance, if I was a pitcher fan, I wouldn't leave. Weird things can happen. A ball gets tipped a funny way, and the ball, I mean, Jay Williams has great hops. Anything can happen.
Last play of the ball game, no matter what. The driller defense looks like it's a kickoff return. Fontana drops back. He throws it up. It's launched. Everybody watching this play. It is intercepted appropriately by Mike Stewart. Will he be our young Wooldridge athlete of the game?
Oh, goodness. That's just uncalled for right there.
What an ugly,
That's uncalled for. And I can tell you, the coaches should get him off the field right now.
Scott Wells with an unfortunate show of extreme unsportsmanlike conduct. He hits probably one of the classiest, talented young men in the area.
They shouldn't even let him get. They shouldn't even let him get in line, Vance. He should be kept up by the coaches, out to the side, and taken to the locker room.
Well, the very last thing we wanted to be talking about after an epic game like this was a poor show of judgment there. So let's forget about it. Here's our final play of the game, and our young Wooldridge, athlete of the game, makes the final interception, the final big play, and it's Mike Stewart. We'll be back, and well, that's just unfortunate right there.
Now, that's okay right there. That's no big deal right there. You know, he had to make a play, and that's fine.
Well, Mike Stewart, jubilant, euphoric, and wow.
I've never said anything bad about a player in my 5 years of doing something, but Vance, that right there is the worst show of sportsmanship, and I think he should be chastised by the coach, whether it's he sits out a quarter next week or something, but something needs to definitely happen. You can't do that. You can't lose your composure like that because you lost the game.
Hey, Kern County Bright House Network subscribers, what a football game. The Drillers hang on and win a big, big, big game, 14-12. This is Vance Palm alongside Brian Adams. When we come back, our young Wooldridge athlete of the game, Mike Stewart Jr. Can't wait to see you on the field. Come right back right after this. Drillers win.
How many pounds?
And the winner is...
With your voice.
But where is... Man, just put it on music choice, man.
Go, go, go.
Don't cry for me.
Music choice. Dozens of nonstop music channels on digital cable. Music choice. Where music happens.
That's the end of this quarter. We'll be right back.
You guys hungry?
Rusty!
Oh, he breaks from the pack and heads for the phone.
Give me the phone.
No.
Uh-oh, trouble from the sibling. What's he gonna do?
No.
Oh, look at that. He's doing the frantic finger dash. Let's see that in slow-mo. Nothing can stop him now. Look at that. Rusty's Pizza, on time every time.
Yeah!
Some things can't be built in a day. Things like honesty, dedication, good hard work, and integrity. Since 1939, the law offices of Young Wooldridge has had one of the strongest personal injury teams in the entire Central Valley. Today, that team is stronger than ever before. Through the years, our attorneys have won some of the highest dollar personal injury verdicts in Kern County. Put our experience to work for you. The law offices of Young Wooldridge, integrity you can trust.
101.5 KGFM, your station for continuous soft rock favorites. Listen at work.
I can feel you breathe, washing over me, and suddenly I'm there.
Listen at home.
Something about the way you look tonight.
Listen in the car.
Meaning of being.
The artists you know, the songs you love. 101.5 KGFM.
Bright House Network Kern County football fans, big night here for Bakersfield High School football. First of all, my far left, Brian Adams, my partner in time and alumni and graduating class of 90. Coach Oliver also here with me. But our young Wooldridge, athlete of the game, Mike Stewart. We always call you Mike Stewart Jr. because we know you're pop. First of all, Mike, tonight you have a new quarterback that comes in. What was the mental state of the team going into a big game tonight with a new quarterback?
Well, we're just real confident in him. We know he can play well. You know, he stepped up big time tonight. He made some great plays, and we knew he could get the job done.
Talking about great plays and getting the job done, Mike, you had a big play early in this football game, a big interception. We're going to roll this here pretty soon. Coach Oliver, this play, can you tell us about the defensive strategy here?
Hey, I tell you what, that's one outstanding cornerback right there, rolling up into cover two and picking that ball off and taking it, as we say, to the house.
Coach, come back to coach here, and we've had, you know, some really great articles written about you. Do you feel like this is a game that gives you kind of an extra nudge?
Well, of course, whenever you win a big game in league play, that's outstanding. But, you know, that was the defending league champions, Liberty High School, and we got to take their hat off. That's an outstanding football team. But tonight, our kids made the plays, and they found a way to win.
Brian, you have something in your hands, don't you?
Yeah, I do. You know, I have the plaque for the Young Wooldridge Player of the Week and a T-shirt for you, Mike. Just want to say what a great game. It was a pleasure for us to do our broadcast and watch you play tonight.
Thank you very much. Just want to accept this on behalf of the defense. Everybody played great.
Michael, appreciate that. Coach, let's look down the road here the next few weeks. Tell us your thoughts.
Well, you know, we got to go back and get to the dry erase board and get ready. We made too many mistakes tonight, offense, defense, and special teams. So we got to go back and get ready for a tough game next week.
Mike, your final thoughts on playing at Bakersfield High School, the driller tradition, how's it feel?
It feels good to get a win, you know, first win against Liberty. And it's just good to get on a roll and just try to keep it going in league and finish out the season well.
Well, we finished our last clip here with you making the last play of the game, interception. Hey, Kern County Bright House Network subscribers, you were looking at the young Wooldridge athlete of the game, Mike Stewart. Coach Oliver, congratulations on a big win tonight. My partner in time, your final thoughts on this big win for the Drillers?
Well, I thought they came in and they played defense, and the offense did enough to get the victory.
Drillers win. This is Vance Palm alongside Brian Adams and these two Drillers. Hey, for this Arvin Bear, I got too much blue around me. Next week, North High School at Centennial. It's going to be a big game. Thanks for all of us for being here, and thank you for joining us. Hey, Bright House production crew, appreciate it. Next week, North and Centennial. Congratulations, fellas. Good night. God bless.